solid. Great. Speed and agility. Harrison Hurst possesses those qualities, plus an incredible vision of the field. That's why he was a Heisman contender in 92. Robert Smith of Ohio State has a chance to be a great college back, but controversy and injuries have dogged his career. Can he move from pretender to contender in 93? Ray Goff's Dogs have won 13 of their last 16 games, and John Cooper's looking for his first bowl victory at Ohio State. And we welcome you to the Citrus Bowl in Orlando, Florida, as ABC Sports College Football is proud to present the Florida Citrus Bowl as Georgia of the Southeastern Conference meets Ohio State of the Big Ten. And Happy New Year, everybody. I'm Roger Twabil, and glad you can kick off your 1993 with us here on ABC Sports, because right after this game from Orlando, Florida, between Georgia and Ohio State, we'll be going out west to Pasadena in the granddaddy of them all, the Rose Bowl, that matching up Michigan and Washington. And then later tonight here on ABC Sports, number one against number two in the USF&G Sugar Bowl. That is, of course, the Miami Hurricanes and the Crimson Tide of Alabama. And we're looking forward to that, of course, later on. So a big day here on ABC Sports, and glad you can be with us. Ohio State University from the Big Ten, the runner-up there, and the University of Georgia from the Southeastern Conference, the runner-up there, have never met before. A couple of great traditions in college football. Between them, seven Heisman Trophy winners and five national titles. And as I introduce my colleague Tim Branton, Happy New Year to you, Tim. This has been a high-powered Georgia offense this year, 450 yards per game. That was a new school record.
Happy New Year to you, and Happy New Year to you, everybody. You're right, and the most impressive thing about that ball club is the fact they turn those yards into points. 32 points a game, and the guy that makes this thing go, you know him, Garrison Hurst, third in the Heisman balloting. He ran for over 1,500 yards this year, 19 touchdowns. Now, Ohio State has said all week they've got to stop this man to win the ball game, so they'll be with him every step of the way. The guy who the pressure falls on then is Eric Zier, the quarterback. Had a tremendous freshman year last year, came back this year. He was strong and solid again, but he's got to be able to throw the ball today. If he does throw, he'll be going to this man, Andre Hastings. He is spectacular. 52 receptions this year. That's a Georgia record. But the most impressive thing, Roger, he can run with the football after he makes the catch. Soft hands, tough body. He's the real deal.
And here are the Buckeyes of Ohio State University. State University, Tim, with one of the best defenses in the Big Ten this year. As a matter of fact, fourth in the nation in scoring defense, giving up 12 and a half a game, and their front seven real tough.
We've talked about this all week. Offense against defense, and Ohio State does have that defense. A defense, they say, is very quick, not only big. The guy who leads the way, of course, is the All-American middle linebacker. That's Steve Tovar. Here is an interesting story. Could have left last year to go to the National Football League, but opted instead to come back for his senior year because he wanted to play in the Rose Bowl. Didn't get there, but he is a player. Now, I think the key to this defense has to be in the middle. Greg Smith, tremendous story there as well. Walk on, earned a scholarship, became all Big Ten, tremendous middle guard. Next to him, Dan Wilkinson, the freshman, he's the sack leader. I think those two right there will be a mismatch with the Georgia guards.
Ohio State and Georgia for the first time ever in the Florida Citrus Bowl. We'll be right back to Orlando after this.
Exclusive is brought to you by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. By Thrifty Car Rental, because it's your money. By Visa, it's everywhere you want to be. And by Red Lobster, for the seafood lover in you.
And welcome back here to the Florida Citrus Bowl. Georgia has won the toss. They've deferred. Ohio State will receive. But first, let's go down to the sidelines. Also working with us today, Mark Jones. And Happy New Year, Mark.
All right, Happy New Year, Roger and Tim. You guys look a lot better without that New Year's Eve lampshade on your head this morning. You know, John Cooper comes in 0-3 in bowl games at Ohio State. His counterpart, Ray Goff, 1-1 in bowl games at Georgia. Interesting thing happened during the week. Goff became a little bit sensitive about some of the coach bashing that went on surrounding Cooper and the job that he's done this year. He's surrounded and defended Cooper numerous occasions during the week. And as a result, the two have formed a mutual admiration society. Yesterday, we asked both coaches about their chances in today's game and what they had to do to be successful.
Well, one thing we have to do to beat Georgia, in my opinion, is we've got to stop Garrison Hurst. We cannot let him carry the football, you know, 30, 35 times a game and get a couple hundred yards rushing. If he does that, they're going to have the football all day. So I think we need to shut him down. We need to force him into a passing situation.
So I think the key is going to be, can we sustain and keep the football to give our defense a break? We don't have a lot of depth on defense, and haven't all year. Their offense is a lot like our defense. It hadn't gotten the credit it deserves, but yet they've made the plays when they've had to. And I think the same thing about our defense. We're one of probably only two teams in the country. I believe Michigan was the other. We're in the top 10 in the country in scoring offense and scoring defense. And if you do that, you're doing something right.
Guys, 72 degrees on the field. Sun just coming out. They're expecting a little cloud cover, so heat might be a problem. But both teams have been here for a while. Ohio State arrived on the 20th. They say they're acclimated. Georgia got here on the 23rd. Ray Goff told me before the game he'd be shocked if his team wasn't ready to play today. Happy New Year, and back upstairs to you two.
And thank you very much, Mark.
Lamp shades. Of course, Mark Jones thought he was the lamp.
Todd Peterson will kick it off for the University of Georgia. And back deep for the Buckeyes of Ohio State, number 33, Butler Benote, and number 26, Robert Smith. And look at the averages, Tim. Those two guys over 27 and 26 yards, respectively.
Both dangerous. I think it's interesting that Georgia wants its defense on the field first. Of course, we talked offensively about the Dogs.
And the kick will go to Smith. He steps back in the end zone. He's going to bring it out. On the sideline. And the official is going to rule him out of bounds at the 17-yard line. They're going to take it back 20 yards to the 17. And we'll set the lineup for you for Ohio State right now. And senior Kirk Herbstreit, see what he's done there. 61% this year. That's an Ohio State record. Brian Stabline, watch him. He is the go-to guy when Herbstreit's in trouble. And there's a look at the backs and other receivers. Offensive line, when they need that yard or two, they'll go on the left side. 290-pound Allen Klein. As Ohio State will take it first and 10. They mark it at the 16-yard line. In motion to Graffenried. And they'll hand it to Smith. Big hole on the right side across the 25 to the 26-yard line. And let's set the Bulldogs defense for you right now. You heard Ray Goff said they were underrated. These seniors do a solid job up front. Wallace, Barnum, and Jackson. The backers, this is a freshman, Randall Godfrey, made over 100 tackles this year. And in the secondary for Georgia, the hardest hitter and a guy with over 100 tackles himself, Greg Trimble. And that's the way Georgia and Ohio State set up offensively and defensively as they bring out the chains to take a measurement.
Joe Hollis, the offensive coordinator for Ohio State, was telling us yesterday that they're going to script the first 15 plays or so and then stay to that script as much as possible just to see how Georgia adjusts defensively, how they can move them around.
Ohio State has the weight advantage up front, Tim, in their offensive line. They go 290, 280, 285, 275, 300 against that Georgia defensive line, which is 275, 260, and 245.
And they're going to see how that goes, too. They want to power Georgia as much as they can offensively and see if, in fact, they can just wear them down early.
They got the first down, so it's first and 10 from the 27-yard line. Play action, Herbstreit near side, and got his receiver at the 44-yard line, and guess who? Brian Stabline, 51 receptions coming into this game, 17 yards on that pickup.
He is the leading receiver, steady, sure-handed. Not great speed, but he is deceptive. Again, good play action, Herbstreit makes all this go with the fake, and then just drops back. They want to get him some high percentage passes early on to build his confidence. And this was not a hard pass, but it was well thrown.
Stabline's now caught a pass in 25 consecutive games for the Buckeyes. First and 10, 44-yard line. Both wide receivers split to the top of your screen. Now in motion to the near side, Chris Sanders. Play action once again as Herbstreit will roll out. Throws it downfield, and the pass is incomplete. Right at midfield, the intended receiver. Over on the far side, number 8, Jeff Cothran, the fullback, as Al Jackson was on the coverage.
And Cothran's going to go back to the huddle and tell Herbstreit he was open early on. when you have that play action and you're trying to hit your fullback in the flats, you've got to do it quickly. Otherwise, everybody adjusts, they catch up to him, and they'll bang him like this. Now watch. Here's the play action. Get it to him right now. He's open. He's got a couple steps on the linebacker. You can see on the right of your screen. But instead, Herb Street holds it too long, gets out of bounds, and now he's just got to drill it in there.
Mitch Davis, 58, put the pressure on him to the far side. Second and 10 from the 44. Stabline split to the near side. One back set for the Buckeyes. And they'll give it to Smith. Gets around the end near midfield, just across midfield to the 49-yard line. Robert Smith with a strong finish to the 1992 season. Had some injury problems early in the year. You see his last four games, 484 yards, six touchdowns, averaging 7 yards a carry. And, Tim, you look at that potential. He's just got to do it on a consistent basis.
Absolutely. You know, John Cooper reportedly got everybody's attention at the media conference the other day when he said he considers juniors Robert Smith and Roger Harper to be first-round picks in April at the NFL draft. And to my knowledge, neither Smith nor Harper has confirmed an intent to leave school early.
Third down and four. Saunders, the tight end in motion. Herb Street, got to come back the other way. Turns it up. In trouble and dumped at the 45-yard line. Mitch Davis, the junior from Mobile, Alabama. 86 tackles on the year and 8.5 sacks. Covers the field laterally as well as any backer. And a man down on the field right now for Ohio State looks like Jason Winrow.
It is, and he's a good one. He's the strongest offensive lineman they have, former discus champion, 6'6", 300-pounder. And if they have a strength, it's Klein and Winrow, their tackles. They are the two best in the Big Ten.
Plus, they alternate freshman Corey Stringer, a 6'6", 310-pounder in there.
Watch the top of your screen, see if we can see this, but here he comes right here. Top of your screen, Winrow, 68. Looks like he gets rolled up on here by the defensive back on that left knee. And that's exactly what they're working on.
So Winrow, a junior out of New Jersey. And most of those offensive linemen, Tim, wear those protective knee braces to begin with. A lot of coaches require them to do so.
And I'll tell you what, they have to. They should wear those, and it should be a requirement. How about Jim Kelly of the Buffalo Bills? Here's a guy. He hyperextends his knee with a knee brace. Can you imagine if he didn't have that on, it would have been blown out.
And you can see Winrow has got those knee braces.
They call those knee braces the Stablers because Kenny Stabler came up with those. Actually, the trainer out there in Oakland came up with those, and they became very, very popular. Everybody does wear them.
Well, that'll bring up a fourth down situation. Fourth and nine as Joel Kessel, the punter in the game. Andre Hastings back deep, the punt returner for the University of Georgia at the 15-yard line. Kessel averaged 35.2 yards for 46 punts, and this is a very high punt. Takes a good Ohio State bounce inside the 20, and that's where it'll roll dead, and that's where Georgia will have it. And we return with 13:06 to go, first quarter, from the Florida Citrus Bowl.
Imagine for a moment a performance car.
They've got a quarterback, the power of positive thinking. This is the most upbeat kid I've been around a long time. Look at his career numbers, second in Georgia history, with 4,232 yards, completions, attempts. Fine young quarterback, sophomore from Marietta.
He will shatter every record, Roger, before he's done.
First and 10 from the 20-yard line for the Georgia Bulldogs. Garrison Hurst to the 26-yard line. And let's check out the backfield and receivers. And we highlight Max Strong, the senior fullback, who many feel is the most underrated player in the Southeastern Conference, if not the United States. Up front, big man there is Bernard Williams, 6'9", 294 pounds. He's big and strong, and Wilkinson and him are going to butt some heads today.
You know what I thought was interesting talking to the coaches? Here you have Hurst, third in the Heisman, and they say Strong is the most important player on the team.
Second and four from the 26. Zaire on the move. Incomplete at the 35-yard line where the intended receiver was Shannon Mitchell, the tight end. And Byron Cook put a big stick on it.
Mitchell slow getting up, too, because Eric Zier left him out to dry. He's looking back for the football. The pass is high, and that's the perfect shot for Brian Cook. I thought Zier should have run this. He had already broken containment. You can see 84 there. That's Powell. He's the outside guy. Instead, Zier throws high, just leaves his tight end up there, and there's Mitchell reaching for it. And then Cook comes in and has the free shot.
Oh, we've got an Ohio State player on the bench. Let's go to Mark Jones.
All right, Roger, Tim, they've just cut the tape off of Jason Winrow's ankle. They're applying some ice right now. The medical staff tells me that they're going to evaluate it after putting the ice on, and chances are that he will be able to go. They're going to retape him, put a brace on it, and see if he'll be able to continue. Back upstairs to you.
Okay, Mark, thank you. Now, so many times when the players have those knee braces, Tim, something's got to give.
Exactly. Yeah. Good point. And it goes down to the ankle. Something has to give, either the knee or the ankle. And, you know, that knee, of course, is the weakest joint on the strongest limb of the body, but it usually is first to go. But if you've got it taped or you have a knee brace, then you're right. Something's got to go, and his ankle went.
Well, Shannon Mitchell left the field under his own power, and Paul Etheridge, 86, will check into the game right now. Third down and four from the 26-yard line. Shift back into the two-back set. They give it to Hurst. Great balance, Hurst. Still going to the 39-yard line. Garrison Hurst. Roger Harper was a man that finally brought him down after 13 yards on the pickup, and he showed you his strength and his agility by breaking that tackle at the line of scrimmage.
Boy, watch this now. Chico Nelson, what I used to call banjo defense, this free safety comes up almost like a linebacker, has a shot on him there, but does not wrap his arms. That leaves Hurst now into the secondary without a free safety because he's already passed him, and now you've got to get support from both sides and the trail guys.
Hurst averaged 6.7 yards per carry, rushed for over 1,500 yards this year. First and 10, 40-yard line for Georgia. Zier got his man. That's number one. You'll see a lot of him today, Andre Hastings. And right now, let's set the defense for Ohio State University. Up front, Dan Wilkinson, the big man, number 72, a freshman, 6'5", 300 pounds. The linebackers, and these are some quick ones. Craig Powell can run step for step with Robert Smith. And in the secondary, look for Tim Walton. He's from the state of Georgia, and he is a powerful hitter. Second down and six. Hurst turns it up near midfield. He'll be close to the first down. Brian Cook, 29, was over there to make the stop, and the man in front of Garrison Hurst was his fullback, Max Strong, who they say is the best blocker, maybe not just of the backs, but maybe of the offensive lineman, too.
Let me tell you something. If they get this first down or close to it, it's only because of that block. Strong put on Powell. Powell, again, was the contain man. Strong went out and took him out, allowed Hurst to get around the corner.
Ray Goff, fourth year, and
look at 84 there, and look at 32 in white. Bang, right there, cut him off, and then Hurst gets outside around Cook, 29.
Third down and less than a yard. They'll go to Hurst. He's got the first down. He's got more inside the 45 to the 43-yard line where Chico Nelson and Craig Powell come up to make the stop. Tim, it's interesting. I did the Georgia-Florida game earlier this year, and, of course, Georgia lost to Florida, and for the third straight year, Garrison Hurst had a subpar effort for him. But he only carried the ball 11 times in that game. Interesting to note, the last two games of the year, Hurst carried over 30 times in each of those games, which Georgia won against Auburn and Georgia Tech. First and 10. Handoff up the middle. Checking in there is Terrell Davis. And Davis coming in to give Garrison Hurst a rest. Gets the first down to the 31-yard line. 14 yards on the pickup for the transfer from Cal State Long Beach, who came to Georgia after they dropped their football program.
Davis could be the best-kept secret in the SEC. He was a transfer, as you said, from Long Beach, and because of Hurst, he doesn't get a whole lot of playing time, but when he's in, he capitalizes. Again, outstanding blocking. Powell tries to one-arm him. You can't. He's 200 pounds. He breaks that, and the big game.
On first and 10, Zier will roll to the near side, and he's got his receiver inside the 20. That's Andre Hastings. 13 yards on the pickup. And this is unusual, Tim, for the University of Georgia. They are a quick strike offense. roughly 60% of their drives covered 60 or more yards in 2 minutes or less. So for them to string together a lot of plays and use up the clock is highly unusual.
I think they're answering the challenge. Ohio State said, we have to stop Hurst, stop the running game. So they're running at them, and they haven't stopped them yet.
Davis still in a tailback on first and 10 from the 18. Zaire checks off at the line of scrimmage. Davis up the middle, inside the 15, down to the 13-yard line. And so far, it's been that offensive line of Ohio State University dominating the people up front for Ohio State. Craig Powell, the freshman from Youngstown, Ohio, came up to make the tackle on that play.
He had to. Greg Smith, we talked about him in the open. The middle guard for Ohio State had a shot at him, tried to one-arm him. They're not wrapping. They're not taking their arms and locking them around the ball carriers. And the Georgia backs are just breaking those.
Second down and four. 9:15 is our first quarter. And Max Strong, the senior from Columbus, Georgia, doesn't get much. But it's interesting that the running backs for the University of Georgia, they all average over 6 yards a carry. Davis over 6 yards. Hurst over 6 yards. Max Strong right at about 6 yards a carry. And Frank Harvey, 6.5 yards. Is Ray Goff a 9-2 year? Still, though, looking to beat Steve Spurrier and the Florida Gators. They haven't done it the last couple of years. That's the thorn in the side of a lot of Georgia Bulldog fans. On a third down and three, Hurst has the pitch, cuts it up. Looks like he's got the first down at the 6 yard line. Mark Williams, 51, the junior outside backer from Upper Marlboro, Maryland, came up to make the tackle as we give that hometown for Tim Brandt's benefit.
Got to get those Maryland guys in there.
Good drive put together here by Georgia. They've had the ball about 5 minutes. First and 10 as they spot it at the, they could first and goal, excuse me, from the 7 yard line. First, gets outside. Good tackle. Touchdown saving tackle on the far side by Roger Harper, the big junior strong safety out of Columbus, Ohio, who goes 6'4", 225.
They say he's so soft-spoken, so polite, yet he is a competitor. Now watch this. They pull the guards, they pull the tackles, they bring him over. Now look, he explodes right here. Now watch 24, Harper in the red. He does save the touchdown. Terrific player. Was a Thorpe Award nominee, but he too has great speed and made the stop from behind.
Second and goal from the 2 yard line. Tenth play of this drive. First. Close. No signal yet.
No, Tobar wouldn't let him in.
Steve
and
Tobar,
so
making the stop.
The Georgia Bulldogs with 7:15 to go. First quarter. We'll have a third and goal from the one and the 11th play of this drive. Tim, they've only had one drive of 12 plays or more this year. This is really unusual.
I'll tell you what else is unusual. Georgia threw 260 passes this year, 355 last year. I remember seasons Georgia didn't go 80 times and throw the ball.
Frank Harvey is the up back. Harrison Hurst set deep. Hurst outside, Bill Boston. His 20th rushing touchdown of the year, and the University of Georgia is on the board first here in the Florida Citrus Bowl.
Freeze it right here. This play is already a touchdown because here are your contained guys. Now watch how they get caught inside and can't get outside. Now Hurst sees that, and once Hurst sees those guys go down, he can walk into the end zone. Touchdown Georgia, big drive for Hurst. Bulldogs were impressive.
Todd Peterson to attempt the point after, only missed one this year. That one's good. And the University of Georgia folks is 7-0 under Ray Goff. When they score first, is it an omen? Could very well be. 6:48 to go, first quarter. Bulldogs 14 plays.
Hurst, 8 carries, 44 yards. You know, Wayne McDuffie once told me this offense, a little bit of Florida State, a little bit of Miami, the old Georgia I, Louisiana Tech, Atlanta Falcons, everywhere he's been. I mean, it's like a mutt attack. It's a little bit of everything. Conglomeration. But what McDuffie, the offensive coordinator, brings is togetherness.
Todd Peterson to kick it off for Georgia. Back deep. Butler Benote and Robert Smith. And Benote is going to say no go. We'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. So good kickoff right there by Todd Peterson. And Ohio State will try to get something working. And, of course, a lot more football coming up here on ABC Sports later this afternoon, because next it'll be the granddaddy of them all, the Rose Bowl from Pasadena with Michigan and Washington. And then later tonight here on ABC Sports, the USF&G Sugar Bowl with Miami against Alabama, 8:30 Eastern time. And, Tim, give me your pick on that one.
Well, you talk about quickness. They both have it. I think Alabama's going to upset Miami.
I like them, too. First and 10 from the 20. Can't make the block, and Smith can't get outside. Randall Godfrey, 6'3", 218, a freshman from Valdosta, Georgia, with 114 tackles this year. The first freshman to lead Georgia in tackles since Nate Taylor did it back in 1980.
Oh, but what a play by the strong safety, too, Mike Jones, to keep that thing strung out and enabling Godfrey to come over and make that tackle.
Loss of a yard on the play. Bring up a second down and 11. Herb Street checking off the line of scrimmage. Inside is Robert Smith. Gets across the 20 to the 21-yard line. Gain of a couple. Not much going inside. It is Damon Ward, the middle linebacker from Memphis, Tennessee, and Mitch Davis, number 58, the outside backer from Mobile, Alabama. Ward getting the start today at middle linebacker. Charlie Clemens has got a bruised jaw.
Watch Klein, though. Klein misses a block here, 67. He tries to come over. They're running a little trap, a little game, and he just runs around everything. Damon Ward, as you mentioned, playing for Clemens today. He's got that sore draw. Took a shot to the mouth.
Third down and 9. Trips to the far side, and Herb Street will roll that way under pressure. Not nearly enough. Greg Beatty, the intended receiver, but it was Mitch Davis putting the pressure on from the outside. And Tim, even if he'd have caught the pass, it was 8 yards short of the first down.
We talked about Georgia's offense and the defense of Ohio State. So far, it's been the opposite. I mean, Georgia's offense was impressive, but I'll tell you this, the dog defense came to play, too.
Well, people, you know, you talk about Ohio State, fourth in the nation in scoring defense, 12.5 points per game. Georgia only gave up 12.8 points per game. They weren't far behind us. Andre Hastings back to receive the punt. He's standing at the 40-yard line. Joel Kessel, a transfer from Dayton. First punt, 35 yards. He's standing at the 7. That's a low, short kick. Hastings is now going to let it go. And it'll get a good Ohio State roll inside the 40, back to the 38-yard line. So a little indecision by Andre Hastings there. Cost his team about 12 yards. And we've got a timeout on the field. 5:40 left to go, first quarter. And Georgia leads Ohio State. Second and goal with 19 seconds left. Tiger running back Joe Frazier fumbled the ball. The officials didn't spot the ball as the clock ran out to preserve the Bulldog win. And Greg Ostend, lay down on it, lay down on it. And that was the Georgia play of the year.
That was one of the most bizarre plays I've seen all year. I mean, the officials just let the clock run out.
It was stranger than fiction, Tim, is what it was.
It was that.
It was goofy.
Yes. In the shadow of Disney World, I'm sure we'll hear a lot more of that today.
First and 10. 38-yard line. Terrell Davis and Max Strong, the setbacks. Sun has disappeared behind the clouds, but look at this run by number 33, the sophomore from San Diego, California, Terrell Davis. Garrison Hurst getting a rest right now, but working hard is Mark Jones. Mark.
Always working hard, guys. And joining me now, Gary and Mary Hurst, Garrison's parents. When's he going to make his mind up, and when's he going to come back?
Well, we're going to try to wait until this ball game over with. After this game is over, we're going to sit down in the room and we're going to talk about this thing and try to come to some kind of conclusion.
Mary, January 6th is the deadline. What about the NFL's labor situation? Has that played into the equation here?
It's probably been the biggest thing that kept them from deciding, because that's probably what kept them from making this decision as early as it is now.
The $64,000 question, guys, to be answered before January 6th. Note to add, Garrison does have insurance with the NCAA, so that ensures some of his financial security. Back up to you.
Thank you very much, Mark. First and 10, ball right at midfield. And in case you didn't hear about it, that proposed labor agreement with the NFL and the players, which looked like it was a go, now has been shelved. So
well, the owner's putting a few more stipulations in. The players backed off. Gene Upshaw said he didn't want any parts of it.
First and 10, play action. Zaire's got a scramble. He's in trouble, and he is dumped at the 47-yard line. Greg Smith, the nose tackle from Canton, Ohio, number 57, was the man to pull him down.
The way things have gone, I suspect Garrison Hurst will come out regardless of what happens. I think the money's going to be there for him. He is a highly coveted player, unquestionably, and I know that Ray Goff has directed him towards some NFL people. They're evaluating the situation. They've talked to people that they respect within the NFL. They are evaluating their value to the league. And if that all comes out, as I suspect it will, you may see Garrison go.
Second down and 13 from the 47-yard line. Garrison Hurst. Across midfield, he gets it to the 46, where Steve Tovar and Greg Smith in on the stop. Smith number 57 and Tovar 58. They're strong up the middle in that Ohio State defense. And Smith, an academic All-American, going to med school. Three-time academic All-Big Ten. And looking forward to medical school at Ohio State University. Just proves, Tim, that you can play sports and you can be a student.
You know, there's quite a few academic All-Americans down here.
Neither of us found that out, did we? Third down and 8 from the 47. Zaire gets out of the trouble. Throws near side, the catch made. On the near side, the man making the catch over there for the University of Georgia. Number 8, Jeff Thomas.
You know, I don't think Ohio State is finishing off. They aren't wrapping arms and tackles. We talked about that. Also, I think they underestimated the escapability of Zaire. Now watch this. He should be going down right here, completely surrounded. But instead, he escapes. He finds a receiver completely composed, and he makes the completion. Here's a guy that he moved 9 times in high school because his dad was a major in the Army, played in Germany in 4 states. Very mature young lad.
First and 10 from the 34-yard line, and Terrell Davis, number 33, is getting a lot of work. Gains about 3. Steve Tovar, 58, 119 tackles this year. 9 tackles for losses. Led Ohio State for 3 consecutive years in that tackle category. 6'4", 240-pound senior.
First guy to lead the Buckeyes in tackles 3 straight years since Marcus Merrick did it. They compare him to Randy Gratishar. They say looks like him, plays like him.
Second down and 7, 2:37 to go as Hastings moves in motion to the far side. They throw it to Hastings. Couple of moves, gets about 4 yards inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. Roger Harper, that's a good matchup. Harper 6'4", 224. Hastings 6'2", 181. Looked like they were trying to set a pick over there or something.
Well, that's what it was. Yeah. It was like the flanker screen. They took it to the man in motion and let the wide receiver become the blocker. I'm surprised at how easily Georgia's moving the ball and how really poor right now defensively Ohio State looks.
Third down and 5. Zaire on the play action. Got a scramble. Can't elude number 91, Jason Simmons. 6'5 and 254, but folks, that's a misprint. He only weighs about 235. 19 and a half career sacks, make it 20 and a half now.
First team all Big Ten. Again, though, you see the feet of Zaire, and watch this. Here's his vision, gets away from that tackle. Simmons is on the ground, but does trip him up. Zaire almost kept his feet, but goes down. Simmons is an interesting story. Criminology major.
Fourth down and 15 from the 39-yard line. It's Armstrong. We'll punt it. Robert Smith back at the 10. Good bounce. Look at this bounce. Something's going right. Something's going right for Georgia. 36 yards on the punt, but it's not so much the yardage as where it went out at the 3.5-yard line.
Another academic All-America, Scott Armstrong. Great pooch punt there. That was a terrific defensive play to stop Georgia
by Ohio State. It was getting to the point where it was becoming critical that they stop them, or we could have a blowout here. So they stop them, and now they get this pooch punt.
Other bowl games, the Poland Wheat Eater, Independence Bowl. Wake Forest comes from behind. Bill Dooley's final game there, 39-35. At the John Hancock Bowl, Baylor stops Arizona, 20-15. In the last game for Grant Taft, the Outback Steakhouse Gator Bowl in the... they need to pull the foghorn out in that game last night in Jacksonville. The Fog Bowl, 27-10, the final there in the Liberty Bowl. Ole Miss finishes up 9-3 with a shutout of Air Force. First and 10 from the 4-yard line. Smith off the right side, outside, and near a first down. They'll spot him out at the 11-yard line. Mike Jones, the strong safety, and Chris Wilson, the left side cornerback, over there to run Smith out of bounds. And Tim, he wasn't far from turning around that end and going for a lot of yardage.
No, but again, you see the strong safety making the tackle. They told us defensively that the strong safety, Jones, needs to play well against that run. And the reason for that is they're using Jones almost like a spy on Smith. He's shadowing him. He's staying on the outside. He's not down the middle where a strong safety normally is.
Second down and 3, just over a minute to go, first quarter. In the Florida Citrus Bowl, Georgia leads it 7-0. The Graffin Reed was the motion man as Smith tries the right side once again, and there's nothing to him this time. He stopped for a loss of about a yard. Chris Wilson, 16, one of the men up there, along with Greg Jackson, the right tackle, 6'2 and 245, the senior from Sharon, Georgia. So the University of Georgia's defense, which loses just 3 players next year, very solid. Ray Goff has got them playing awfully well. Richard Bell, of course, the defensive coordinator. Tim, you gave him a tip yesterday, didn't you? He was all worried about what defense to run. What'd you tell him to run?
I told him set those outside people in the 9 technique and bring them on the outside.
Third down and 3. The Graffin lead in motion once again. And once again, it's Smith. And he gets the first down across the 15-yard line. Randall Godfrey, 42, and Damon Ward, 53, in the middle to make the stop. What a lot of people forget about Robert Smith. He's got good size, Tim. He's strong.
He does have good size. He's 6'2", almost 200 pounds. He, too, is a medicine, has aspirations of getting into medicine and being a doctor. But, you know, we joke about Richard Bell, the defensive coordinator for Georgia, but he comes out, he's got a terrific defensive scheme.
That ends the first quarter of this Florida Citrus Bowl, with Georgia leading Ohio State 7-0. The Florida Citrus Bowl. I'm Roger Twabell, along with Tim Brandt, Mark Jones. Happy New Year to all of you out there. Glad you kicked off your new year here with ABC Sports. First of 3 games today, as Georgia leads Ohio State 7-0 as we start the second quarter, 1st and 10 from the 16-yard line, as the Graffin Reed goes in motion for the Buckeyes. Straight up the middle, powering it straight ahead, is Robert Smith, and the offensive surge right there by the Ohio State Buckeyes creating some room. Damon Ward and Greg Jackson on the tackle, and let's check those stats from the first quarter, Tim.
Roger, they say the best defense is a good offense, and that's what Georgia's done in the first half. Just first of all, look at the rushing yards right here, 72. Total yards, 104. They've dominated, but this is the important one right here, the time of possession. Almost 11 minutes of the first 15, the offense of Georgia has been on the field and not given Ohio State the opportunity to get theirs going.
And this is from the quick strike Georgia offense, as once again they go to Smith and he goes nowhere. Stopped right at the 21-yard line by Greg Jackson, who this year made 105 tackles. Not a big man playing that defensive line, 6'2", 245, the senior. Good quickness, good pursuit. Robert Smith, of course, rushed for over 1,000 yards his freshman year at Ohio State. Hey, there's my favorite dog in the world.
Oh, good.
Okay. But Smith rushed for over 1,000 yards his freshman year. Then a controversy, his sophomore year, decided to sit out that season. Now back this year. Had some injuries early in the year, but finished strong.
Uga looks like a lot of people field today.
3rd and 4 from the 21. Herbstreet's got his man wide open at Stabline to the 35-yard line, where Chris Wilson makes the tackle, 14 yards on the pickup.
His 53rd catch of the year. Watching from the left side of your screen, he just kind of drifts his way out. Looks like he's going to block. Now comes in under the zone, finds the open area and then turns and tries to make positive yardage out of it. And Wilson, the right corner, makes the stop. Stabline's brother Chris was a quarterback at Ohio State. Got a shot with the Dolphins.
Two receptions, 31 yards. His brother's the one that got him to walk on at Ohio State out of Erie, Pennsylvania. First and 10, 35-yard line. Single back, and that's Cochran as he tries the left side. Cochran, the big fullback from Middletown, Ohio, 6'2 and 235, a junior. A little weak at that position today because Eddie George, the outstanding freshman from Philadelphia, has got a bruised shoulder, probably won't see action.
Hey, what a great collision between Jeff Cochran, who's 235 pounds, and Randall Godfrey, 42, 6'3, 218. Watch this. Bam, in the hole, head on. And they fall sideways. It's a draw. Nobody wins.
Godfrey, terrific year for this freshman. 114 tackles to lead the Bulldogs. 69, that's what's impressive. You can jump on a lot of piles, but man, when you get them by yourself 69 times, that's something. Second and nine, as Herb Street doesn't like to run with the football, is going to run for the sideline as he is collared out at the 35-yard line by Maurice Harrell, the sophomore out of Eastman, Georgia. Ohio State, Tim, pretty basic in their offensive set. When they have the one back in there, a couple tight ends, they're looking at Robert Smith when he's there to run the football. When Smith's not in there, they're going to try to throw it a little bit more.
Not difficult to read. What they do, Roger, is they use their size and their strength, much like what the Washington Redskins do. They feel like they've got the talent, even if you know what's coming, to make that thing work just by execution. And for most of this year, they've executed quite well.
Well, Joe Hollis, the offensive coordinator at Ohio State, was the offensive line coach at Georgia before moving up 3 years ago. Third down and 10. Ohio State 2-4 on third down situations, and out of the shotgun, Herb Street will roll right. Going back across the grain, dangerous pass right there. Greg Beatty, the intended receiver. Mike Jones, number 9, and Chris Wilson, 16, there on the coverage. And it looked like he had Stabline open right in front of him.
Primarily a zone defense they did that time, and you're right, Wilson and Jones both broke on the football, got good breaks. Now watch this. Get a little hit. Now get into your hook area, your zone. All right, now he looks open, but watch the safety in the corner come over, read the eyes of the quarterback, try to get it at its highest point, and just knock it away. That, folks, is good defensive football.
Joel Kessel back at the 20 to punt it. Andre Hastings at his own 20 as the sun breaking through once again here in Orlando. It's been hiding behind the clouds a little bit today. Hastings at the 25 and eludes one tackle. And Hastings gets it across the 30 to the 32-yard line, 40 yards on the punt. And 11:50 to go first half. Georgia leads it 7-0. 7-0. And the Bulldogs will have the football, first and 10 from the 31-yard line. A report out of the Long Beach Telegram, Press Telegram, says that Larry Smith, the head football coach at the University of Southern California, has been fired. Now, ABC Sports will try to track that story down. No confirmation from school officials. We'll work on that the rest of the day and see if we can bring you up to date on that story concerning Larry Smith and the University of Southern California. Pitch back to Garrison Hurst. Spins. Gets up to about the 33-yard line. Gain of a couple of yards. Garrison Hurst had this to say about his counterpart, Steve Tovar of Ohio State. Asked him what he thought of it.
I met him earlier this week at a parade we had to do for the, I guess, Disney World. And he's a nice guy. I mean, I've seen him play a lot. I mean, evidently, he's a great player. I mean, he's All-American. The film that I've watched on him, he's the lead on the field. So, I mean, it's going to be a great matchup between, you know, I don't see him that much. Maybe if I see him, he'll see the back of me, you know. But, I mean, it's going to be a great matchup out there.
Second and 8 as Zaire throws it across the field. The reception made at the 48-yard line by Brian Bohannon, the junior from Griffin, Georgia. 19 yards on the reception, just his 18th reception of the year.
You know, talking about Larry Smith, and we are following that story up at USC, him being fired there. The USC-Arizona game, I was out there and talked to Larry before the game and asked him about his job. And he said, yeah, he had taken a lot of heat from the alumni, and he says, if I lose out the rest of the year, I'm in serious trouble. And the fact was, he did. He lost his last 3 games, and consequently now the report is that he's been fired.
5-1-1 start, then they lose to Stanford, to UCLA. Hurst. Garrison gets a couple on that carry. Hurst with 21 touchdowns this year, 19 of the running variety, two touchdown receptions, 6.8 yards per carry, both single season Georgia records. And this is a Georgia offense, depending upon what Garrison Hurst does, that loses only three players next year.
Roger, one of the things we talked about in the pregame were the guards of Georgia, Roberts and Taylor. We felt like Smith and Wilkinson of Ohio State would have the advantage, but so far Swan is double-teaming with Taylor and Roberts, depending on the side they go, and they've been doing a nice job on both those Ohio State Buckeyes.
Second and eight from the 47, play action. And Zier's got some room. He's going to run it. Hits a screen over there as he runs out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Looked like his tight end, Shannon Mitchell, who was an intended receiver, saw him running and just sort of screened his quarterback off from his pursuer. Chiefs beat the Chargers twice in the regular season. Can they do it three times? And will Stan Humphries be helping?
One of my former coaches, Bobby Ross, now at San Diego.
Third down and three. Hurst trying to get to the outside. Very close to the first down, but no, they're going to say he stepped out at the 41-yard line.
I really thought Bobby Ross was going to be the coach of the year in the AFC. Instead, Cowher got it from Pittsburgh. But great job out there by Bobby Ross.
Chico Nelson and Randall Brown in on the tackle. Nelson, one of several players from the state of Florida on the Ohio State roster. That'll bring up a fourth down and two for the University of Georgia with 10-12 to go. First half, Scott Armstrong back to punt it, and Robert Smith back deep. Low, wobbly kick. And they're going to down it right at the 11-yard line. Max Strong was right down there to down it, 30 yards on the kick. But once again, Ohio State in very, very poor field position. And with 10:04 to go, first half, Georgia leads Ohio State 7-0. And welcome back here to the Florida Citrus Bowl in Orlando. Georgia leads Ohio State 7-0, along with Mark Jones and Tim Branagh. I'm Roger Twibel, and a happy new year to all of you as we begin the first of three big bowl games here on ABC. And now we'd like to pause 5 seconds to allow our ABC stations to identify themselves.
TV5 WEWS Cleveland.
First and 10, Ohio State, poor field position once again from the 11-yard line. Hand off. The deep back that time is we've got a change here. Raymond Harris, number 34, 6'2", 226-pound junior from Moraine, Ohio, gets the carry. And Godfrey and Charlie Clements, number 48, up to make the tackle. So after using Robert Smith extensively, Coach John Cooper goes to Raymond Harris.
Harris is more a tackle-to-tackle type guy. He's not going to get on the outside. And I think right now with his poor field position, Cooper's just trying to bang it back out, try to get back out where they can do some things. And once they get out there, I wouldn't be surprised to see him come with a reverse a little bit, because right now Georgia's being very aggressive, and if they can come back with a reverse, they'd go against that.
Second down and eight from the 13. Hurst is smothered right there. 89 for Georgia was all over him. That's Philip Daniels, the true freshman from Donelsonville, Georgia. 6'6 and 205, and there was nowhere to go. John Cooper has not won a bowl game at Ohio State. A lot of pressure has been on him. I had a chance to talk to him. I asked him how his life was up in Columbus, Ohio these days.
Well, I'm proud to be the football coach at Ohio State. You know, everybody talks about the high expectations of... If we didn't have those kind of expectations, Roger, I never would have left Arizona State to go to Ohio State. Nobody wants to win more than I do. And we have all the resources to win. We've got outstanding high school players. We've got tradition. There are many schools in college football that can, you know, that's had more Heisman Trophy winners, the more Outland Trophy, the Lombardi Trophy. We've had over 100 All-American players, 25 Big Ten championships. So that's one reason I'm there. A lot of pressure, but nobody wants to win more than I do, and our coaching staff does.
Was a very successful coach at Tulsa, then Arizona State, went to the Rose Bowl, and taking some time to get it done up at Ohio State. But 8-2-1 this year, their best winning percentage record since back in 79. And on that third down and 12 play there with the pass to Cedric Saunders, they got the first down, as you see Cooper's record against ranked teams and then bowl teams.
You know, with all his success, though, he has not beaten Michigan. He's lost three straight bowl games, as you mentioned, so I suspect he does feel the pressure, despite what he says.
So first and 10 on a big third down completion from Herb Street to Cedric Saunders, his tight end. And the ball up at the 21-yard line for Ohio State. They trail it 7-0. Raymond Harris. Good bit of running there around the left side, and they've got another first down up to the 34-yard line with Buster Owens, a redshirt freshman from LaGrange, Georgia, finally makes the stop, 13 yards on the pickup. And, Tim, they can go deep at running back, Ohio State, with Smith Harris and Butler Benote.
Absolutely. I think it's interesting you were talking about Harris being tackle to tackle, and he takes that ball outside. You know, his nickname is Quiet Storm, and he likes to be known as the ultra back. So he breaks outside that time and moves the chains again.
First and 10, 35-yard line. Single back in there right now for Ohio State University. That's Cochran on the play action. Herb Street's going to go deep. Intended receiver was Chris Sanders, the sophomore from Denver, Colorado. Greg Trimble and Al Jackson back on the coverage, and it looked like Sanders, who's a long jumper for the Ohio State track team, was trying to get in the air just a little bit early to make that reception.
Long jumper, you bet. 26 feet, 9 inches and 3 quarters. Watch this, though. Good play action, but he only sends one guy deep and one under. So now the zone, 2-deep zone now, converges on him. Watch Trimble takes the inside spot. They ride his hip, and this is great coverage.
Tim, we talked about Georgia being a big play team. The Bulldogs have had 11 touchdowns of over 35 yards this year. Ohio State with just 3 touchdowns of over 35 yards. So they grounded out. Big 10 stop. Second down and 10. Play action to the near side. Herb Street trying to throw against his body that time. Never squared his shoulders up. Pass was short and incomplete. The intended receiver was Greg Beatty. Player down for the University of Georgia at the 29-yard line.
Looks like it's Greg Jackson. He's usually all over the field. Great success story, too. He ran into some academic problems a year ago, worked as a security guard in Atlanta, took courses and got back into school. He's a new man, much more mature and religious, and gets along very, very well now with Ray Goff.
Isn't it unbelievable when you're a college kid and you have to leave school for one reason or another and you get a 9-to-5, and then, man, it makes you want to go back to college, doesn't it?
I can empathize with that, too. I think when you get that free ride, that scholarship, you take it for granted. Then when you're thrown back out and tossed into the real world, you say, hey, wait a minute, that wasn't all that bad. Training table, free ride, get my classes, my education. Looks like another roll-up on his ankle. Now watch the right side of your screen. You can see right there, 54 in white. His right leg gets caught underneath. Yeah. And Hartman, 52 for Ohio State, just rolled up on that ankle. Not illegal, good block. Jackson just couldn't get his feet out.
So far today, Greg Jackson with 2 solo tackles, 3 altogether. And backing him up over on the right side is Travis Jones, number 51, a junior from Irwinton, Georgia, and he is checked into the game right now as Ohio State has got it. Third down and 10, 35-yard line. Been no penalties so far in this game. 7:45 to go, first half, and out of the shotgun. Kirk Herbstreit, the senior, the first recruit by John Cooper at Ohio State, will move up into the pocket. Bad pass there. The receiver wide open is Brian Stabline. And once again, the Buckeyes will have to punt the football.
Brian's disgusted with himself, too. He knows he should have made that tackle. Herbstreit got excellent protection. They brought Stabline underneath. Everybody else had gone deep. The ball was there. He should have had it.
Kessel will come in. Senior from Massillon, Ohio. He's standing right at the 20-yard line. And back deep is Andre Hastings. That's a nice punt by Kessel. Tight spiral. And Hastings looked like he called the fair catch, and he did at the 25. Maybe he forgot. You know, sometimes if it's a good punt and you make that fair catch call too soon.
No whistle was blown immediately. He didn't hear the whistle, so he decided to run. Smart play on his part. Finally, they did blow it, and they just marked the fair catch.
You got good ears, Brand, I'll tell you that. A Well, the University of Georgia is celebrating its centennial football season along with three other Southeastern Conference schools, Alabama, Auburn, and South Carolina. So far today, 81 yards on the ground, but they'll go to the air with Eric Zier going to Hastings and a catch at the 47-yard line. Beautiful throw. Roger Harper was there, and that was a nice timing pattern, Tim, between Zier and Hastings. 23 yards on the pickup.
Number one, Zier is an outstanding quarterback. Play action fake. He sets. He looks. No pressure at all. Great protection by the offensive line. Then here comes Hastings. Andre, we talked about in the pregame as well. Outstanding receiver. Does a nice job of sliding behind the secondary on the outside and making the catch.
Zier's hit his last six passes on first and 10 from the 48-yard line. They bite on the fake, but he finds his tight end, Paul Etheridge, the senior from Atlanta with just his fourth reception of the year. Steve Tovar was there to make the tackle.
He is the Etheridge family's fifth generation at Georgia. Here again, all the motion goes to one side, the fake, roll out, and there's your tight end, wide open. He's a big target, too, 6'6", 240.
Wet and Wild is a proud sponsor.
I get a kick out of Hastings. We were talking about him to play before. He makes that catch, and it really was nice. At practice yesterday, they threw him a pass, and it went through his hands and hit him in the face. The players dogged him all day. He was all upset.
Did he have his helmet on?
He says, you wait until the real deal tomorrow in the game, and I'll be there.
I saw a guy that went through his hands one time and stuck in his face mask and wearing a grab there. No problem, man. See the yards, Bulldog offense.
What did you do once it got stuck in your face mask?
You just pull it out and run, man. First and 10, 42 yards on it. 7:03 to go, first half. First is in the slot to the near side. Fumble by Zier. And Ohio State has recovered. First turnover of this football game with 6:52 to go, first half.
Randall Brown was the first guy to get there. And as soon as that ball was on the ground, Brown was on top of it. Now here's a guy that was an outside linebacker in the spring. Brother Kendall plays at Louisville, 6'3", 260. But look at his reaction getting down on the ball when Zier mishandles it. That's quickness.
Bulldogs were best in the nation last year, committing only 14 turnovers. This year they committed 26, and eight of those were in their two losses to Tennessee and Florida. So, best start today for Ohio State from the 46-yard line with 6:52. Left to go first half, and we've got a timeout called by Ohio State. Georgia leads it 7-0. Bowl games, that's the most in NCAA history, and besides the Citrus Bowl and Sugar Bowl, did you know they played in the Presidential Cup Bowl, Tim, the one and only?
Now, do you know where that was? College Park, Maryland, on the campus of the university, way back in the 1950s, although this is the 100th year of football for Maryland, too, and the game they all talk about is the 1955 game when the Queen of England was there, the Queen's game.
They lost to Texas A&M 40-20 in that Presidential Cup Bowl with Robert Smith. Got the first down to the 41-yard line. Big pickup on first and 10 with 6:44 left to go first half. 14 yards on the pickup as Trimble and Ward made the tackle. So after getting the turnover, having to call the timeout because they were not going to get the playoff, they come back with a good solid play on their first down possession, and they've got it first and 10 at the 40-yard line of Georgia. Smith, once again, following the middle of the line, inside to the 38, and we've had a few injury problems so far in this game. Let's check in with Mark Jones and get an update. Mark?
Yeah, Roger, one of those injuries, Greg Jackson, who sprained his right knee, I'm told, just a few moments ago. The medical staff had just changed their mind. They said earlier they were going to fit him with a knee brace and let him go back into the game, but now they have slapped some ice on it, and they'll evaluate it at halftime to see if he can continue. Meanwhile, Jason Winrow, the offensive lineman for Ohio State, who was injured earlier, is back in the game and seems okay upstairs.
Okay, thank you, Mark. This is the furthest that Ohio State has been into Georgia territory in this game on second and 8 from the 38-yard line. Once again, Smith. Not much there off the right side. He gets a couple. Damon Ward was the first man to get to him. Ward 53, 66 tackles this year, sophomore from Memphis, Tennessee. This Georgia defense, 29 and a half sacks this year. They forced 15 fumbles. They had 12 interceptions. They allowed 12.8 points per game.
Damon Ward, one of the surprises for Georgia. The coaches were surprised at how he came on. And should mention also that Travis Jones is the guy who's taking Greg Jackson's place at right tackle.
Third down and six. 5:05 to go, first half. Georgia leads at 7-0. They're coming hard from the outside as Herbstreit throws a bad pass. Penalty marker is down. The intended receiver was stabilized as Herbstreit saw some pressure coming from the outside. But a penalty marker is down. That'll be the first one today. And Ohio State is signaling that it's against Georgia. See the referee there?
Offside on the defense.
Dale Phillips, the crew from the Atlantic Coast Conference. So offside on the defense. Tim, it looked to me like it might have been Maurice Harrell, number 49, on that right side of that Georgia defense.
That's exactly right. They were trying to come with the blitz. He's normally the drop guy on a pass, but he was coming from the outside on that blitz and just tried to anticipate the count and got across too early.
So that'll bring up a third down and one at the 31-yard line. As Mark Jones mentioned, Jason Winrow is back in the game, number 68 at right tackle. Smith, after the long count, needs to get to the 30. Looks like he did. Paul Long, the center, a senior from Highland Heights, Ohio, 6'5", 282. This was a guy that the Georgia defensive people were very concerned about. Felt that he was very strong. It would cause him some problems. And that's where Smith went, right behind him.
Ohio State now having some success on third down. They're 4-for-8. But again, look at the line surge. All the red jerseys fire out. They get their penetration. And then Smith follows it up for the first. But it's the long count, hard count, trying to draw them off sides that really made that thing go. Softened up the defensive front of Georgia.
First and 10, 29-yard line. In motion there, number 17, Chris Sanders. And Smith will try to cut it back against the grain as he gets near the 25-yard line where he's pulled back immediately. 49, Maurice here. Also 92, Tom Wallace, the left tackle, the senior from Madison, Ohio, the only player from Ohio on the Georgia roster, junior college transfer from Allen Hancock, J.C., out in California. 78 tackles this year, 6'6 and 275.
Wallace and Harrell got out the rake. They were trying to rake that ball out of Smith's arms.
Must be a big game for him coming out of that state of Ohio. Had to go the junior college route, ended up in Georgia. Second and 7. Georgia's dipped into the junior college ranks a bit the last few years to help beat things up. As on second and 7 from the 26, Herbstreit. Throwing back against the grain, and he's got his receiver, Beatty. Greg Beatty, the senior from Houston, Texas, comes up with the reception and the first down. Mitch Davis and Damon Ward putting pressure on Herbstreit, who hasn't had a lot of success, Tim, rolling out of the pocket and trying to throw to them.
No, but stop it right here, and you see the block that Smith's giving him right here. But then he tries to throw back against his body. Tough pass, great completion. Watch this. Going to his left, throws back to his right. Finds the little break right there, the open area, and hits Beatty. That's a tough pass to throw.
Herbstreit's the most accurate passer in Buckeye history. Completed nearly 60% on first and 10 from the 18-yard line. Watch this man move, Butler Benote, and you'll see him in the football game a lot when they get inside the 20-yard line because he's so versatile. He can catch the ball. He can run with it. Wallace and Jones in on the tackle. Take a look at Benote, nearly 5 yards a carry this year.
Cannot tell you how much the blocking has improved on this drive. First of all, stop it there. All right, this area is all sealed. Here comes the lead blocker. Look at this. That's the area. Now let it roll, and you see 85 Saunders there leading the way. Watch the block he gets. Turns it up. Bingo. Yardage. Nicely done.
3:10 left to go. First half. Player being helped off there for Georgia. That's Chris Wilson. As you see the rush and pass selection so far today. Benote, the deep back, on second and four. Butler and Benote turns it up inside the five to the 4.5. And Ohio State's got something working here.
Exact same play again. Saunders with another big block on the corner. Oh, they're muscling it now. Watch this. You talk about the muscle. All right, let's go back the same way. All right, stop it here. Here he comes. This is Saunders. Watch this block he puts on the corner to allow this to pick up positive yardage. Bam!
He's the tight end pulling out to the other
side. Exactly.
Yeah. First and goal. They spotted at the 5-yard line. Benote, with just one rushing touchdown this year, is out of the game, and Smith is back in, and he gets it. Smith. Ooh, he was close to the goal line and then stood up at the 1-yard line. Greg Trimble, 24, and Chad Wilson, 19.
That's right. Those two made the contact, and then Jones came in and actually took him back the other way, away from the goal line.
How hard did he hit him?
Bam. Rattled the fillings, put his eyeballs up in his forehead.
Second down.
Watch this. First of all, those two guys will stand him up. All right, here it comes. First hit, second hit. Now watch number 9 come out of the right of your screen. Bam, and put him right on his side.
15th play of the drive. Second and goal from the 1. Coughlin. First man through. No signal. They went to the fullback. Jeff Cothran, the first man through, and Torrey Evans, 45, one of the initial defensive players to come into contact with the fullback. Clock running down now. 1:34 left to go first half. And for Ohio State, third and goal from the 1. Smith gets the score. That was about as easy as Garrison Hurst had it going in. Almost the same play, Tim.
What a great block by Jeff Cochran that time. He isolated the right cornerback, Chad Wilson, and pancaked him. You get a big block right here, and I'm telling you, that is big.
Well, Tim, the fumble by Georgia leads directly to this touchdown by Ohio State, as Tim Williams will come on to attempt the point after to tie it up at 7 apiece with 1:17 left to go first half. And for Robert Smith, his 9th rushing touchdown of the year. Pick is up and good. 103 out of 105 in his career at Ohio State for Williams, and we're tied at 7. And Robert Smith, we talked earlier, the dog by some injuries, controversy. Some folks say, well, he's a track guy wearing shoulder pads.
UPI National Player of the Year, his freshman year, then sat out, as you mentioned, and then missed spring practice because of track. But look at this block right here on number 19 by Cothran. You see him right there over the official shoulder, and that's just, once you lose blood control defensively, there's nobody outside to make that stop.
What Robert Smith has got to do is put together one consistent, solid season of football at Ohio State, dispel his critics. Now, he has not been talking to the media down here in Orlando. It's been controversial. The talent is there, though. The physical skills, the ability.
Talent is there. How about Cooper, though, saying that he considers Robert Smith and Roger Harper both to be first-round picks in April in the NFL draft.
Well, Smith is just a sophomore eligibility at Ohio State. Even though he laid out that 1 year as Hastings would take the kickoff, he was a little undecided about it. And probably not a good decision, as he is tackled at the 9-yard line. Coming down to make the stop there was Tito Paul. And, of course, a lot more college football coming up here on ABC Sports next. It's the Rose Bowl from Pasadena, Michigan, against Washington. And then later tonight, it'll be number 1 against number 2, the USF&G Sugar Bowl from New Orleans, Miami, and Alabama. That's at 8:30 Eastern time. Georgia's got all of their timeouts left, as they'll start it from the 8-yard line with 1:10 left to go. Let's see if they'll try to move it down the field, try to get it in field goal range, as Zaire's going to work out of the shotgun. And they'll hand it off inside. Carrying the football is Max Strong. Gain of about five. Greg Smith, the nose tackle, came up to make the stop.
All right, now Georgia will go to their hurry-up offense. Zaire will try to get them back up. They've got their timeouts left. They want to work this clock. Still plenty of time left, 50 seconds.
Just wanted to move it out away from their end zone a little bit. Zaire down the middle has got Strong. Strong has the first down as he gets it to the 25-yard line. And that'll stop the clock on the first down. 14 yards on the pickup to Max Strong, the senior out of Columbus, Georgia, had 14 receptions this year coming out of the backfield.
Stops the clock to move the chains. Zaire gets them up quickly again, but they do have all three timeouts.
Got a penalty marker down, and also checking out the left ankle there is Garrison Hurst.
I think it's going to be a personal foul, late hit on Zaire. If it is, tack 15 more on.
Hurst is running off the field, but hobbling on that left ankle.
Let's take a look and see if it was a late hit. Here's Zaire, ball's gone now.
Oh,
no question about it, it's late.
That was a Big Daddy Wilkinson that came in there. And that's a big late hit, folks. That's 6'5 and 300 pounds by Dan Wilkinson. Freshman from Dayton, Ohio, and they're going to step it off.
So they do tack 15 more on. Now let's see what happened to Hurst. Left hand of your screen up top. See him trying to throw a block. Here comes. Oh, he gets rolled up on his left leg
by Max Strong, his teammate.
Zaire looks so comfortable, so in control. There's number 10, the same number one at Georgia by Fran Tarkenton and Ray Goff.
Ray Goff is a running quarterback for Georgia. Played in this bowl game, it was called the Tangerine Bowl. First and 10, 41-yard line after the penalty. Zaire pump fake. Now he'll throw it to Max Strong, who's trying to get out of bounds, but doesn't. A gain of two up to the 43-yard line, and Georgia will burn another timeout. Well, you know, there's a lot of coaches in college football that are a little bit superstitious. Tim, I think Ray Goff is more than a little. Here's what he had to say.
Well, I eat the same thing every pregame. When I get up for a brunch, if we have a brunch, I'm going to eat three donuts every time and put them in the microwave for the exact same seconds. But I'm not superstitious. It doesn't bother me at all. Eat the same thing for, if we got spaghetti or what, I'm going to eat the exact same thing every week. I used to, when we went 4-7, we were 3-1 early in the year, my second year, and we had some difficult years, and I'll never forget when we're 3-1, my wife was putting X's on the underpants to make sure I wore the same pair of underpants. Then we lost 6 out of the next 7, and I threw those suckers away. I'm never worried about that again, I can promise you.
I'm glad he threw it away, too. He did all right, though. Ray Goff finished 7th in the Heisman balloting in 1976 and married the head cheerleader, Stephanie.
Well, Garrison Hurst is back on the field. 23 seconds left to go. First half, Georgia and Ohio State tied at 7. Second down and 7 as the Bulldogs with two timeouts remaining. And hope you've gotten off to a good start here in 1993. Glad you can be with us here for this Florida Citrus Bowl between Georgia and Ohio State. First meeting ever between these great football traditions. And Zaire works out of the shotgun. He's hit his last 9 passes. Good protection off the fingertips of his intended receiver, Hassan Graham. The sophomore from Decatur, Georgia, had it right on his hands. Walter Taylor was there on the coverage, and Walter had a chance at it, too.
That ball should have been caught, though. They've got tremendous protection out of their offensive line. Zaire throws a strike. Now watch this. Graham comes in, the ball's there. He's got to make that catch. They make that, they're almost in field goal range.
Third down and 7. Coming near side, and there is a guy who's got some hands. Brian Bohannon makes the reception, and out of bounds should be enough for the first down to the 47-yard line.
How can you not like Zaire? Now watch Brian Bohannon. Just a quick out pattern, and this ball is thrown on a rope. Remember, you only need 1 foot in college football.
Second catch for Bohannon. Big game of the year for him was against Ole Miss, where he had 4 catches, but he caught a 24-yard touchdown pass against Florida. On first and 10, they're going to the far side, and no. Wait, now the back official comes up. No, they're going to say no. Didn't get the foot in. Receiver over there was Hassan Graham. So with 5 seconds left, they'll bring it back to the 47-yard line.
All right, now you've got one play left. You got a couple of options. You can put everybody out there and just throw it up for grabs and try to score that way. Or you can put a little fancy thing in there, maybe a little hook and lateral. But they're going to go and put all the receivers out to the top and just throw that thing up for grabs and hope their guy can go.
Hassan Graham, the only receiver to the near side. Zaire going in the direction where those three receivers were, and somebody went up there and made a catch. A lot of people have the football. It's not going to matter, though, because time has run out in the first half. Andre Hastings looked like he was the Georgia man. Roger Harper was back there for Ohio State.
It is a catch. Watch this. Hastings goes up to this ball and takes it away from everybody. Number one, middle of your screen. Watch these hands. All right, now everybody's got a hand on it. Hastings somehow comes down with it, so it is a catch. You'll see the official at the top of your screen say Georgia football. But time expires. Gain of 39 yards for naught.
We'll return with more action from the Florida Citrus Bowl after this message and a word from our ABC stations. We're tied at 7 at halftime.
Coming up next on ABC, it's the Rose Bowl, Washington against Michigan, and Dick Vermeil. Washington trying to become the first team to win 3 straight Rose Bowls.
Well, they dominated last year. I can't see them doing it this year. Michigan is a much better balanced football team, both running and passing. Much better team, closer football game.
Number 6, Tyrone Wheatley is one of the big reasons why they're a better team.
Great football player. I mean, he's big, fast. There isn't anything he can't do. They're getting the ball to him coming out of the backfield. A real problem for the Huskies.
Should be quite a matchup coming your way next here on ABC.
The USF&G Sugar Bowl game following the Rose Bowl here on ABC Sports. The national championship game, number 1 Miami against number 2 Alabama. And Bob Greasy, let's make sure the world understands now that Copeland and curry is not a dish. You don't eat it. If you're a quarterback, you run for your life because those big guys play defense for Alabama. But this whole game, this whole matchup is defense, isn't it?
Well, it's a championship game, and you know the old cliche, you don't win championships without great defense. Alabama comes in number 1 in total defense in the nation. Miami is number 3 in scoring defense in the nation. They're led by their outstanding middle linebacker, Michael Barrell. But you still have to have some offense. But defenses generally never have an off day. Sometimes offenses do.
But both teams are loaded with people that can run on the defensive side of the ball. For example, the Miami linebackers. Heck, they can outrun most running backs. So if you want to see strategy, field position, defense, watch us right after the Rose Bowl.
And welcome back here to Orlando, the Florida Citrus Bowl. We get set to start the second half of play between Georgia, their head coach Ray Goff right there, and Ohio State University and their head coach John Cooper. We're tied at 7. I'm Roger Twibel along with Tim Brandt and Mark Jones. As I don't know, Tim, I think maybe we expected a little bit more offensive punch from both teams in the first half, even though these are both good defensive teams.
I agree with you, Roger. As a matter of fact, the first quarter was all Georgia offense. The second quarter was all Ohio State. As a matter of fact, Hurst, 71 yards in the first quarter. He only had 9 in the second.
Let's go down to Mark Jones. Mark.
Roger, Tim, on the first day down here in practice, Tim Williams, the Ohio State place kicker, broke his wrist when Steve Tovar ran into it during a kicking drill. Now, he wears 2 different casts on his right wrist. One of them is a soft one, which he's wearing now. The other one is a hard one, which he wears when he's not playing. I asked him, does it affect your kicking, Tim? He said, Mark, you know, strangely enough, it gives me more weight and torque on the right side of my body, and it straightens out my kicks, and I'm not hooking them quite as much anymore. Back upstairs to you.
Hey, Mark, he was just kidding you. That's a that's a kicker answer, isn't it?
I tell you what, when you can get torque on it, that really gets it going.
Oh, man. Set to go. Hastings and Hurst back deep for the University of Georgia.
Now I know why you always wear those casts when you play golf.
That's right. Williams with a high kick that Hastings will take at the 6-yard line. As the sun is shining brightly right now. And Andre Hastings, near side. And guess who knocked him out of bounds? Tim Williams, the kicker. Number 23 at the 45-yard line with a touchdown-saving tackle. 49 yards on the return.
Hide and seek, hunt and peck. Watch this. Right now, he's just trying to get back to the 20. Makes a move here and gets two blocks. Now he sees another alley coming up here. See how they wall that off? No more blockers, so he's just trying to get as much of the yardage as he can there, and then Williams knocks him out.
Hastings averages over 27 yards per kickoff return this year. Georgia, first and 10 from the 45-yard line. Garrison Hurst down to the 42, and let's take a look, Tim, at those halftime statistics.
Well, we were telling you it was like two different quarters, two different teams. You can see the time of possession now is almost even. As a matter of fact, it was heavy in the favor right here of Georgia in the first quarter. Then it came back and it's been even out in the second quarter. But I think still, as you look at these statistics, the big one to me is Hurst had 17 carries, 71 yards in the first quarter, to 6 carries, 9 yards in the second quarter.
Second down and 7. Garrison Hurst breaks a tackle. Inside the 30, looking and go. All the way inside the 10 to the 9-yard line, where Brian Cook finally knocked him out of bounds. 34 yards on the pickup. Man, he shows you some speed once he gets it to the outside.
He must have taken a look at those second quarter statistics and didn't like them. Nelson missed the tackle, and all of a sudden, once he gets outside, he does have a great burst of speed. Look at the block. Boy, last year he missed a lot of practice time early working on academics and had to play catch-up all year. This year he came in on time, and he's been strong all year.
14 carries, 90 yards for Garrison Hurst as Hastings goes in motion. First and goal from the 8, and Hurst has got it. The middle, pounds his way inside the 5 to the 4-yard line.
Roger, he just looks so comfortable in his offense, in the stadium. You know, he played here in 1990 in the Florida Georgia High School All-Star Game, ran for 180 yards and scored a touchdown in that game. So he loves this place. We talked about Tovar 58 in the pregame, but watch how they seal him off. He comes through, looks like he's going to get there, but a terrific block up front.
Second and goal at the 5-yard line. Zier on a quick slant. Hastings, the intended receiver, he was well covered right there. Number 18 was back there for Ohio State University. Tim Walton, the native of Columbus, Georgia. 6 foot, 170-pound junior.
Third and goal.
So Georgia here on the opening drive of the second half off the run back by Andre Hastings.
You wanted offense, Roger. You're getting it.
Third down and goal from the 5-yard line. Hand off to Hurst. Spins. Gets loose. Touchdown. Big time move right there by Garrison Hurst.
Told you Craig Powell, the weak side linebacker, was missing tackles. He wasn't wrapping up. I want you to watch 84. Stop it right here. Here comes 84. He's got one arm on him. Let it roll. No shot. Cannot even get over to him.
16 carries, 98 yards, 2 touchdowns as Todd Peterson knocks it through. And that quick strike offense is back. That drive took all of a minute and 33 seconds as Georgia leads Ohio State 14-7. A humid day here in Orlando, Florida. After the clouds had burned off, foggy this morning. Garrison Hurst sitting by that cooler down there,
getting a little
oxygen. Third quarter has been the Bulldogs' quarter this year. They've outscored their opponents 101-17, and that quick strike offense back in force as the kickoff down to Butler Benarte, who fumbles it and goes out of the end zone. And Ohio State will take over first and 10 from the 20-yard line, but. What a big lift for the Bulldogs. Special teams setting it up with the kickoff return by Hastings. And there's the first half possessions by Ohio State. Wasn't pretty until they finally got good field position, Tim.
And they started blocking better, too. Now, they made some interesting adjustments in the second half, in the second quarter. Started going after the perimeter, getting better blocks up front from Hartman, Long, Mano, and Winrow. And that really made a big difference. If you look at Herb Street right here, he was 4 for 10. Smith had 63 yards. So they were getting a little balance out of there, but still, Herb Street can play better than he did in that first half.
Well, you got to keep in mind, he's had 3 passes dropped also in that first half. First and 10, 20-yard line. Herb Street rolls near side, save line. And they say no. So what did Georgia do defensively in the first half?
Basically, they've stayed with their zone. They've got a lot of pressure up front. Looks like Wilson has been very active. Godfrey and Tremble, too. Tremble out of his free safety spot. And they've been using him a lot to bring that pressure. They put Jones on the outside. That also helped defensively.
Smith will check back into the game along with Sanders on a 2nd and 10 from the 20-yard line. Georgia leads it 14-7. Just underway, second half from the Florida Citrus Bowl in Orlando. Smith has it. Smith up to the 30-yard line, close to the first down. Chris Wilson, 16, was the man that rode him out of bounds. Cedric Saunders was leading the way. The tight end giving him a block. Saunders, a native of Sarasota, Florida. And they're going to say, yeah, it is a first down. This is what Smith has done so far. So as we build at the top, Hurst and Smith, you have seen why Garrison Hurst was a contender for the Heisman Trophy, and you are seeing why Robert Smith could well be in 1993. 1st and 10, 30-yard line. Cochran, the lone setback. Pump fake. And Hurst speed
on a keeper.
Well, that time he wanted to make something happen quickly over the middle. It just wasn't there, and he was stuck, Tim, with nothing to do.
Oftentimes when he pulls it back, that's exactly what happens to him. He does get stuck. He's not a great mobile quarterback. He's not a great runner. As a matter of fact, this year, he's run the ball 70 times because he's more or less had to, and he's lost 41 yards.
Interesting. The Ohio State coach has told us that at one time, as you take a look at Eric Zier right there and his numbers, that Herb Street was going to move to safety. As a matter of fact, they put him over there for a day or two. But they list his qualities. You got to say leader. Pretty good athlete.
Players love him. They named him co-captain. Blue-collar quarterback, but he's a winner.
His dad was also a captain at Ohio State. On 2nd and 8 from the 32-yard line. Time and down the middle. There's another pass drop a little bit behind the intended receiver, Stabline. Seems like Timmy's just in a bit of a hurry with his release.
Stabline should have made that catch, but you're right. Hurt Street is in a bit of a hurry. You talked about his daddy playing at Ohio State. Of course, that was in 1960 when he was the captain there. Interesting story that Kirk Herbstreit will tell you. His dad used to take him into the locker room after he'd gotten out. He used to sit on the lap of Woody Hayes. First met him when he was 4 years old. Sat on his lap and said, at that point, I want to go to Ohio State.
You know, someone here this week said there are two coaches trying to replace legends. One a living legend, Vince Dilley, the other deceased legend, Woody Hayes. A lot of truth to that. 3rd down and 8 from the 32-yard line out of the shotgun. Stabline drops it as he was nailed. Randall Godfrey came around, number 42, and put the big-time hit on Brian Stabline, who is down, and he is hurt.
How many times do you see it? The high ball across the middle, you know you're going to get hit, but if it's high, you're exposed, and it's the perfect shot any defensive player wants. Randall Godfrey knew he had it, knew the receiver Stabline wasn't looking at him, and just drilled him. Now, there is a flag on this play, but watch the hit that Stabline 88 takes here. Wow.
Randall Godfrey, double figures in tackles 7 times this year, and right there, he had a clean shot at Brian Stabline coming across the middle, and that is a receiver's worst nightmare, to be exposed for that kind of hit.
Godfrey, the leading tackler, he's the heat seeker, very instinctive, aggressive linebacker. He was the state of Georgia's top linebacker last year in high school, and I mean to tell you, that, folks, is a slobber knocker.
Ohio State's leading receiver this year, 51 receptions. That's twice as many as any other Buckeye receiver. And he's being helped off the field right now.
You know, this game has become so violent with players so big and so fast now. I'm surprised that it's not a requirement for all players to wear that pro cap, that extra helmet on top of the helmet, which would give everybody a little more protection.
You know, Tim, I'll tell you what, I don't know what you can do. I mean, it's a game that's played by big, strong, fast men, and you're going to get hurt. And I don't know if there's anything else you can put on your body that's going to help you at all. 4th down and 8. just in the front, inside the 20. It's a high short kick, and Georgia and Hastings making the fair catch at the 39. It's going to have good field position, 30 yards on that punt, so Georgia's going to get it back in good field position once again with 12:54 to go, third quarter. And here's what Georgia did in their first half possession. Started out well with a touchdown, a couple of punts, and then the fumble, which then Ohio State converted into the touchdown. And this year, Ohio State scored 51 points off 25 turnovers. So they've taken advantage of the other team's mistakes.
The key to that, Roger, was the fact that Georgia had excellent field position almost the entire first half.
First and 10, 39-yard line. Ball carrier right there is Max Strong, and he is tackled at the 42. Coming up is Brian Cook, a senior from Youngstown, Ohio. This defense of Ohio State will only lose three starters this year, as they had many of the best defensive marks in the Big Ten this past year. Best pass defense, scoring defense. Good future.
Brian Cook is one of those guys that will be lost. He is a senior. Had that reconstructive knee surgery last year. Lost a step, but he is still solid in that defensive backfield.
Second down and 8 from the 41-yard line. Second back three is Garrison Hurst. Spins. And I'll tell you, Tim, you got to love the way that Hurst, when he feels the contact, immediately spins and looks for that daylight.
The great ones never do offer their full body to the tackler. He's like a whirling dervish. He does. He's like just like a pinball. When he feels that initial contact, goes with the flow, bounces off of it, tries to use that to force momentum in his run.
Third down and 5 from the 44. First, 17 carries, 100 yards, and Zaire Strong. He knew where the stick was. I don't believe he got there. He needed to get to the 49-yard line. It's going to be real close as Zaire went to Strong. Right now, let's go down to Mark Jones. Mark?
Yeah, guys, the medical staff from Ohio State just told me moments ago that Brian Stabline has a partial tear of his medial collateral ligament in his right knee. He is through for the day. He is disgusted, and just a few moments ago threw his mouthpiece out, showing his disgust. He is done.
It's a quick diagnosis for that injury.
Just took his eye glare off, too. You know, they used to do that with cream, almost a gel. See, he just ripped his off. It was almost like a little piece of material.
There's a low spiraling kick on fourth down, and that will go in the end zone. 52 yards on that punt by Scott Armstrong, and with 11:04 to go, we'll be back to Orlando after this. There's a very disappointed young man, Brian Stabline, a senior from Erie, Pennsylvania, with the knee injury. Could very well be the last game of football he ever plays.
You know, that's not the injury I anticipated out of that hit. I thought he had gotten his bell rung a little bit, and the way he was holding his face, but it turns out the ligament tear.
First and 10, Smith. Quick opener off the left side across the 25 to the 26-yard line where Randall Godfrey, he's been the big play man. 114 tackles this year and made the hit on Stabline, which knocked him out of the game. Blockbuster Bowl, Stanford 14, Penn State 3. That score at halftime. Once again, coming up after this game will be the Rose Bowl from Pasadena, California. Later tonight, the USF&G Sugar Bowl, number 1 against number 2. 10:30, left to go, third quarter. 14-7, Georgia leads Ohio State as Smith looking for room, got it off the right side. Robert Smith up to the 38-yard line, and good blocking that time by Paul Long, the center, Dave Mono, the right guard, and Jason Winrow, the right tackle, on the 12-yard pickup.
He's like Houdini on this play. He finds a hole that's not even there. Comes off the right side. Now watch this. Bam, just big enough to get through, makes his cut. When you ask the coaches, say, Coach, can you describe Robert Smith? They say, very intelligent, hardworking, extremely talented, who continues to mature.
19 carries, 91 yards. Is Cothran right up the middle that time. Cothran close to the first down. Greg Trimble comes up to make the tackle. And that time it was the option. They gave it to Cothran right up the middle. And once again, good blocking there by Long, Mono, and Corey Stringer has just checked into the game. He's 6'6", 310 pounds, a freshman, number 78 from Warren, Ohio, who is the Big Ten Freshman of the Year.
He's a low 310 pounds.
You believe these guys are 300 pounders coming out of high school, Tim?
That's when your parents say, man, I can't wait till you go to college. Get on that training table. You're eating me out of house and home.
First and 10, 48-yard line, 9:32. Up to go, third quarter, Smith.
That's back to Smith.
Down to the 47-yard line. Maurice Harrell, 49, came up to make the stop, but it looks like Ohio State is going to stick with that ground game. That's where their success has been.
And the Buckeyes are moving so much better now. I don't know if you saw Len Hartman, the left guard, get out in front of the play that time. Cothran got out. He was a leader. This could be the best fullback that Georgia has seen this year.
You mentioned Hartman, academic All-American, English education. Second and four. Smith one more time. That time, gain of just about a couple. Didn't see much there, and he has the tendency, Jim, to take it when in doubt to the outside rather than cut it back up like he did on that carry a few moments ago where he picked up 12 yards.
I was watching Randall Godfrey. He runs to the ball so well. You know, he almost went to Florida. Almost went to Florida. Loved his visit there, but there was something about it. Just like Richard Bell when he came to visit in Georgia, down in Athens, and then decided to stay.
Third down and three. Georgia has moved into... Ohio State has moved into Georgia territory. The Buckeyes 5-10 in third down situations. And they try to run the quick pitch inside. Man, that's a dangerous play right there, especially on a third down situation. Little shovel pass from Herb Street to Smith. And I don't know, Tim, whether Smith fumbled that ball momentarily, and the officials are talking it over.
Well, it can't be a fumble. It's either an incompleted pass. Actually, it's a very safe
actually,
play.
If he fumbled it after he had made the grab.
No fumble, incomplete pass.
Oh. I guess, yeah, see, Ray Goff is saying he caught it, which is what I thought. He caught the ball, and then he fumbled it.
Well, here it is again. Again, you'll see number 52, Hartman, pull. Then they try to slip it underneath. Now, here comes Smith. Here's the little shuffle pass. Now, does he have possession, or is he bobbling it right there? Davis riding his back, so you can't tell from that angle whether he was bobbling it or whether he did have possession. If he had possession, he obviously took two steps before the ball came in.
Kessel to punt it, standing back at the 40-yard line. Little or no wind here today at the Citrus Bowl in Orlando. That's a nice high spiraling punt. And that goes out of bounds at the 11-yard line. So... Ohio State tried a little razzle-dazzle on third down. You said you liked the play. I felt they had been at their strength, just that straight-ahead blocking and running the football. That's what they've been doing best so far.
Well, I think Joe Hollis, the offensive coordinator, was just trying to break from tendency, be a little bit more unpredictable. That play is usually successful, and it is fairly safe. It's the old Utah pass that Lee Groskopf used to run all the time, and if you can get it under there to Smith and get him by that first line of defense, then it can turn into a big gainer.
First and 10, University of Georgia, 8:36, left to go, third quarter. Garrison Hurst, across the 15 to the 16-yard line, gain of about five. Randall Brown, sophomore from Detroit, Michigan, came off the left side to make the tackle. 14-7 the score with 8:20 to go third quarter here at the Florida Citrus Bowl in Orlando. And scoring so far, Georgia Bulldogs got off to the quick start on their opening drive. Garrison Hurst, the one-yard touchdown run, made it 7-0. Then Robert Smith with a one-yard run. That tied it at 7, and then Hurst, the five-yard touchdown run. And so far, Hurst with 18 carries, 105 yards, and two touchdowns. Now, last year in the Independence Bowl, Tim, in which Georgia played, Hurst did not have a big game. It was more Zaire and Hastings. And one of the things that he was talking about was he wanted to have a big bowl game to show people that he could play in those big games.
He never really caught up last year. He got that late start because of academics and never really got going like he did this year. He's a heck of a baseball player, too. He may play baseball for Georgia.
Third down and five from the 16. Intended receiver downfield was Brian Bohannon, number 84. He was well covered. The ball was thrown low. Roger Harper was back there on the coverage. So good stand by the Buckeye defense. And they should get good field position after this punt.
Punt formation for Georgia.
Scott Armstrong standing at his 1 yard line, and Walter Taylor at the 45. And that's a low line drive kick taken right at midfield, and Taylor right up the middle with it. Taylor still going inside the 35 to the 33 yard line. First and 10, 33 yard line. Best field position for the Buckeyes since the fumble recovery back in the first half. And right up the gut and running hard, Raymond Harris down to the 25. Tim, this is what I mean. I'm just watching what Ohio State has done well today. It really hasn't been their passing game. It hasn't been the razzle-dazzle. It's just been straight ahead, man-for-man blocking, and just run it down their throats.
Well, I agree. That is where their success has come. They are so big and strong. They average about 284 yards, 285 yards across that front. And right now, they're dominating the line of scrimmage.
8 yard pickup by Harris. Second down and two from the 25. Now, Herb Street, he was thinking about a timeout, and then he thought about it again, and he said, yeah, I better call it.
He looked at the play clock, yep. And it was down to 2 seconds. He started to call it, so maybe I can get it all up, and it was down to one. He says, a timeout.
That's the second time today that Herb Street has had to call a timeout because the play clock was in danger of running out. So he's with Joe Hollis over the side. Joe had a funny comment the other day. We were talking about his move from the University of Georgia to Ohio State. Joe in the white shirt with his back to you right there. He says, well, the easiest thing was for my wife because the colors are very similar, so she didn't have to really buy too many new game day outfits from the red and black of Georgia to the scarlet and gray of Ohio State.
It was funny. He said, obviously, when he coached in Georgia and he came over, the colors for him doesn't change much. I mean, a sweatsuit is a sweatsuit, workout clothes are workout clothes, but you don't want your wife having to get a whole new wardrobe. That'll cost you. Nice man.
Herb Street this year, 4 touchdown passes, 5 interceptions. See what the Buckeye rushing. 8 wins, 219.6 per game. The 2 losses and a tie, 98.6 today, 138 yards.
They're on the cusp.
Yeah. I mean, for them to be successful, their game is the running game. Second down and 2 from the 25. D.J. Jones, tight end, moves over to the near side. He's number 89. Right up the middle, and the first down, no problem by Raymond Harris. See, they've just got so much size up front with Hartman at 280, Long at 285, Mono at 275. In the middle of that defensive line for Georgia goes 260, 245, and 270.
But you know that play that you were talking about, the little shuffle pass, mm-hmm. the Utah pass, that's basically like a running play. Yeah. I mean, you're still using their block, and it's like a trap or a counter tray.
First and 10, Raymond Harris one more time, trying to get to the outside. Gain of about 3 on the play before Chris Wilson, the left cornerback out of Macon, Georgia, brings him down. Wilson's a versatile player for this University of Georgia football team. He's played a lot of different positions for him.
Roger Smith and Hurst were compared all week, you know that, and both are special athletes, but there's a difference in their holiday spirit. Robert Smith said he'd rather be home spending the holidays with his family. Hurst said, hey, he loves his family, but he'd rather be here playing than sitting home watching.
Second and 6. Smith now, 21 carries, 98 yards, as Sanders is the motion man as they give it to Smith. That reminds me from where he sets up there of the old Southern Cal, power eye, deep back there, let those blockers sort of move out on the men, and then he reads to where the hole is.
Very much so, read and react. But I think that's what made that Utah pass, why it came into Joe's mind, why he would call something like that, because then when the defense gets very aggressive, then let them run out and just try to slip it in under them.
Smith has gone over the 100-yard mark today. Third down and 3. The ball at the 13. Ohio State needs to get to the 10. The Graffenreid and Beatty are split to the top, and they'll go to Robert Smith one more time, and he's going to be very close. He's going to be very close. See where the official spots it.
Depending on that mark, you're not kidding. He's right up near it, but I'm not so sure he got it. Hey, did you see the quick stick yesterday? Instead of the chains, they're using that quick stick. I don't like that at all.
It's almost folks about it.
Well, the quick stick, you don't bring out the chain. You bring out one stick. It has like a measuring stick on it. You just set it on the line, then you open up the, almost like a slide rule type thing.
New innovation. Yeah, you're just an old timer at heart, Grant. You know that?
I definitely am.
Stuck in your ways.
Look how close that is.
Okay. Big call for John Cooper and Ohio State here. 4:34 to go. Third quarter. They trail at 14-7.
Now we'll see if that big offensive line can fire out.
Buckeyes 8 of 12, 67% on fourth down situations this year.
I'm a big believer in a short yarded situation like this. Don't risk a handoff. Don't take time. Just quarterback sneak it right up behind Long, who's probably the best center in the Big Ten.
They've got 42 William Houston in at fullback. He's 6'1", 260 pounds, essentially a guard wearing a running back number. He's in front of Robert Smith. Sneak it. Good call right there. Good call by Ohio State, and Herb Street gets the first down. Man, all those backers, everybody was focused back there on Robert Smith, and Herb Street just went around the center.
Absolutely. Well, that's what I'm saying, especially when you got a guy like Long in front of you. 6'5", 280, the best center perhaps in the Big Ten. High school wrestling champion. Watch this. Herb Street knows where they're coming, just trying to go in between them. Saw 45 Evans, just went opposite.
First and goal from the 9, Smith down to the 5-yard line. Chris Wilson comes up to make the tackle, and this offensive line right now, Ohio State dominating on this drive. Once again, they had the good field position off the short punt and the return.
You know, John Cooper, the head coach, he looks at this game as a way to recruit Florida kids. He hopes this will attract more players from this area. There are 3 Floridians on the roster now. He likes them. That's Tito Paul and Chico Nelson and Cedric Saunders.
Second and goal from the 5. Smith. How about this? He scores in twice today. Len Hartman 52 on the left side of that Ohio State line. Huge hole.
Well, if John Cooper wants to showcase his team to the Florida kids, he did it right here. I'm telling you, untouched, just open that thing up and flowed into the end zone. Pretty, pretty drive.
Tim Williams to attempt the point after. Good.
Boy, that was Big Ten power football.
3:31 left to go, third quarter. From the Florida Citrus, that touchdown to Michigan. Kirk Herbstreit completed a 5-yard touchdown pass to Greg Beatty in what Ohio State fans call the play of the year. They went on to tie Michigan 13-13, and that scoring drive, 8 plays all on the ground, 33 yards, 3:41, and Smith the 5-yard touchdown run. Taylor had the punt return off the short punt, and Ohio State has been able to take advantage of the fumble by Georgia in the first half of the touchdown, and then the poor punt and the return set things up. Williams kicks it off, and Hastings has got it at the 10. Andre Hastings, 33-yard line, and a late flag. A late flag on the play. Walter Taylor came down to make the tackle.
I'm not sure what this flag is, but I'll tell you this. Brian Bohannon got away with a push in the back.
Well, maybe it was on Brian Bohannon.
It might be. Georgia split in.
No, Ohio State. You know, the players signal before the officials.
We have an illegal block in the back after change of team possession on the receiving team. That's a 10-yard penalty.
Yeah, so they did catch him. He didn't get away with it.
A lot of college football yet to come here on ABC Sports on this New Year's Day 1993. Coming up next, the Rose Bowl, Michigan and Washington. And then tonight here on ABC Sports, you'll see from the USF&G Sugar Bowl, the battle for number one, Miami and Alabama, live at 8:30 Eastern Time.
I think Stallings and Jay Barker have taken offense to the fact that Miami's saying he can't throw. that the red shirt sophomore is a liability?
I don't know. You know, he, within certain limitations, he's a good quarterback. I don't believe he's lost a game as an Alabama starting quarterback. As Georgia has a first and 10, and they swing the pass out to the far side to Frank Harvey, the junior from Dawson, Georgia, who had a big day on the first play of the Georgia-Florida game when he went 80 yards for a touchdown.
No huddle, hurry-up offense here. They just want to get Ohio State kind of out of sync defensively.
Out of the shotgun now, second and 5 from the 28. Zaire is able to get rid of it, and coming back to the football, Hassan Graham, and they said, yes, he made the catch close to the first down at the 34-yard line where Tim Walton was there to make the tackle.
I love Eric Zaire. Here's a kid, he was recruited by everybody, got serious with Florida State, Alabama, Notre Dame, and Georgia, and decided to come to Georgia in Athens. Now, he is such a good student, he finished his senior year of high school in Athens at the university on an early admission waiver from the NCAA. But look at this, the escapability. Watch him throw on the run. Just puts it on a rope. And the catch of the game.
Listen, Wilkinson was chasing him all 300 pounds, and you can see how fast Zaire runs when that guy's after you.
Again, they go hurry up, no offense, or no huddle, rather.
And they got the first down, first and 10, 33-yard line. Zaire, the shovel pass this time to Hurst, and no way.
You do
Lorenzo
not like that play.
Stiles was right there, the freshman from Farrell, Pennsylvania.
You do not like that play.
There's too much risk in that play. There's the Mobile Cotton Bowl. Notre Dame leading Texas A&M 21-0 in the fourth quarter. That might be a bit of a surprise to some folks.
It's a surprise to me, but then when you think they took Greg Hill out of that lineup, that makes a major difference.
Second and 12. Zaire's got Hastings at the 40-yard line and collared right there by Chico Nelson.
You know, Hastings and Garrison Hurst are best friends. Extremely competitive. Matter of fact, they raced one day. They thought each thought the other was faster than the other one. They raced out in front of the dorm. Garrison Hurst lost. He wouldn't go back inside until he raced him again. Stayed out all night.
Hastings, 6 receptions now for 89 yards. And Georgia's trying to wear out this Ohio State defense right now. Running these quick plays. Going out of the shotgun on 3rd and 3. Hassan Graham with the catch. Nicely done at midfield. Perfect throw from Eric Zaire. Tim Walton was there to bring him down along with Roger Harper.
You are seeing a masterpiece from Eric Zaire. He is a big time quarterback. This ball has to be perfectly placed. It is. Graham goes up and gets it. The only place he could between the two defenders.
First and 10 right from the 50. And off goes inside, and Frank Harvey cuts it out as he gets to the 45-yard line where Lorenzo Stiles, number 90, and Randall Brown, 56, come up to make the tackle. Harvey getting some playing time, junior from Dawson, Georgia.
He's like a guard wearing number 7 and stuck in the backfield.
245 pounds. I had lunch with him the other day at the banquet as Zaire goes downfield to Graham, just past his outstretched hands. Walter Taylor was back there on the coverage, but at the luncheon the other day for the Florida Citrus Bowl, they had players from each of the teams at the tables, and Harvey was at our table, and Dick Schultz from the NCAA said, I can't eat all my prime rib, would you like to help? And he had about 3 other pieces of prime rib there. Everybody kind of slid it over for Frank Harvey.
I bet if he didn't have a game today, he'd still be there eating.
3rd and 5 from the 45-yard line. The shoulder pad of his intended receiver, Andre Hastings. Chico Nelson was back on the coverage, and I think the coverage was so good that Hastings never saw the football.
No, he didn't, and it's another one of those that hit him in the face mask. They'll have to punt it now. What they'd like to do now is just pooch this thing and get Ohio State backed up, but they had a good drive going, and then the incompletions, and here they are punting the football away.
48 seconds left to go. Third quarter, Scott Armstrong, junior from Jackson, Mississippi, sends one deep, and that's going to go into the end zone. So after what looked to be the start of a pretty good drive by the University of Georgia in their hurry-up offense mode, well, their There's a helmet that'll protect you. In touch football.
Hardly see the guy in there.
Ohio State will get it back with 40 seconds left. We're tied at 14 in the Florida Citrus Bowl. First and 10 from the 20-yard line. And at the Blockbuster Bowl, Stanford leads Penn State 14-3, third quarter. Of course, Penn State making the move next year to the Big Ten, and they're on Ohio State's schedule. Chris Wilson makes the stop. Benote is a 5'11", 190-pound junior out of East St. Louis, Illinois. He's an All-American sprinter on the 4x100-meter relay team at Ohio State. Ohio State has a lot of track guys besides Robert Smith. Benote, Sanders is their long jump record holder.
Well, those are the three that missed spring practice to be with the track team.
We've completed three quarters of play from the Florida Citrus Bowl. We'll return with more action after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Florida Citrus Bowl in Orlando, Florida, where we start the final 15 minutes. Ohio State and Georgia tied up at 14 apiece, and second and five from the 25-yard line for Ohio State. The intended receiver, Allen DeGraffenreid, and poorly thrown that time behind and above the senior from Cincinnati, Ohio.
Good coverage by Al Jackson right there. They call him a blue-collar corner, but still best cover guy they have, and he was in good position that time.
See some of the scores here. John Hancock Bowl, Baylor beat Arizona 2015. Outback Steakhouse Gator Bowl, Florida over North Carolina State. I'll tell you, Shane Matthews, if he could play in the Gator Bowl every game in his career, through 10 touchdown passes there in four games.
Hey, I've got a question for you. Second down, why would Ohio State throw the ball when their running game was going so well?
They're 5-12 on third down conversions. Good question, Tim. Third and five from the 25. I guess you have to show it once in a while. And down the middle, Robert Smith with the reception. And it's going to be very close to the first down. He needed to get to the 30.
He had the first down, tried a spin move, lost yardage, and I'm not sure he got it now, depending on the mark.
Blockbuster Bowl. Stanford leads Penn State in the third quarter.
They're not even going to measure. They need about a foot more. And that'll cause a punt. So he had the first and then lost it.
It's a mistake by a player who's trying to get a little bit too much when he didn't really need it.
You're right.
Joel Kessel will go back to punt, standing at the 15-yard line, his seventh punt of the day. And Andre Hastings at the 35, so conceivably Georgia should get good field position on this next possession. That's Kessel's best punt of the day. Gets a big bounce and will be downed at the 19-yard line. So Kessel with his best punt of the day, and 13:45 left to go. After the 52-yard punt, Georgia will take over. They've been in bowl games 12 of the last 13 years. First and 10, 18-yard line. Zaire got a man wide open downfield at the 35-yard line. The reception made by Brian Bohannon. And I'll tell you what, Ray Goff now, are they going to wave that off?
I think they waved it off, and Goff can't believe it.
Oh, Ray Goff. Let's take a look at it.
Here's the pass. There's Bohannon. All right, now hold it right there. There's his foot right on the line. Out of bounds, good call. What are you looking at me for?
Well, I don't know. It looked like one of them was in.
Yeah, but the first one was out of bounds. So it doesn't make any difference what the second one does.
You were sure.
I'm positive.
You're sure from up here. Okay. Second and 10. Zaire going right back to that side. Hastings is over there and overthrown. Back on the coverage. Roger Harper looked the wrong way, or he might have had an interception.
You know, what's amazing? I was just about to say, Zaire has really found his rhythm. He's in sync now. He really feels confident. He threw that one to Bohannon. It was so close. Now he comes back, and that pass wasn't even close.
Third down and 10. Zaire with good numbers today. Georgia, 8 of 13 in third down situations. Out of the shotgun. Takes the handoff inside. Zaire's got room. He's got a man, Hastings, at the 36-yard line, and Goff points down that time. He was right there.
That's right.
It was in.
He was the first one there. This is set up nicely. Looks like it's going to be one of those little draw plays, and then all of a sudden, Zaire gets outside again. The flood control and throws a nice pass here. Now watch. 1 foot. Now watch the right of your screen. Let that thing roll, and you'll see. Here comes Goff. Here he comes. Hey, he was in that time.
He's just trying to help those officials.
That's right. He wants that side judge to know that he is in the ballgame.
Big third down play there. First and 10 from the 36-yard line. Right side, he gets about three. Max Strong, number 32, is brought down by Brian Cook, coming up from the left cornerback spot. Ohio State's defense this year, statistically their best since the 79 Ohio State team that went undefeated to the Rose Bowl, where they lost. This year they finish 8-2-1. Once again, just so few points separated both of these teams from undefeated seasons.
Bomb defense right now. I'm looking for Garrison Hurst right now.
Second and 7. 12-4 left to go. Tied at 14 on the play action. Zaire down the middle. Finds his tight end, Shannon Mitchell. To the 42-yard line. 18 yards on the pickup, where Mark Williams makes the tackle.
Shannon Mitchell took over when Chris Broom graduated, and Mitchell was the SEC All-Freshman, 20 receptions this year. His high school was 29-1. Mr. Football in Tennessee, watch this. He goes up and gets this baby, 6'3", 242 pounds, and then goes down hard. Nice play.
From Alcoa, Tennessee, hometown of Lynn Swan. They know how to catch the football.
Yes, they do.
First and 10, 42-yard line.
At least those two do.
Pitch back, Harrison Hurst. Still running hard, got the first down at the 33-yard line. Boy, so far today, it's been the Hurst and Smith show. Both of these players with a 1-yard touchdown run and a 5-yard touchdown run. Both have over 100 yards rushing. Smith with 112 and Hurst now with 114.
He averages 141 yards, Hurst does, so he's trying to gain up now in his average. I'll tell you this, Georgia running backs include Herschel Walker, Lars Tate, Rodney Hampton, and others, but Hurst doesn't take a back seat to any of those guys. He's definitely the most complete player.
They're going to give the mark about a foot and a half short of the first down. So what appeared to be a first down by Garrison Hurst will bring up a second down in less than a yard. .11:56 left to go. Ray Goff, born and bred to coach at the University of Georgia. Grew up in the state, played his college football there, went away as an assistant for a couple of years before coming back as an assistant, and then finally being named head coach 4 years ago.
This is what you call a waste down, second and short, knowing you can always come back on third down to get the first, so not a bad time to go long.
Hastings in motion. He's got the first down, and he's got more. Inside the 30 to the 28-yard line with Byron Cook. Makes the tackle. So that big third down pass play. And all of a sudden, Georgia has got it down in Ohio State territory. As you look at that running back comparison, so close today. And once again, both the touchdowns of 1 and 5 yards for both players. First and 10, 27-yard line. Hastings in motion. Fires nailed at the 35-yard line. Ball came loose. Steve Tovar made the hit. And did they call it a fumble?
Yes, they did.
Greg Smith was the man that pounced on it. So the sack by Tovar, his third of the year.
Watch Tovar. He gets there first. Zaire never sees him coming. Bam, ball's loose. All right, now watch Wilkinson, I believe, that comes over. And I thought this was a late hit, but the ball is there and you can't see it. And he came in and landed on the ball. Here's Tovar again. And watch, he sees that he's got the blind shot. Let this thing roll and see if we can see Wilkinson coming in and grabbing that ball. Here he comes. He gets the fumble.
First and 10, 36-yard line. Ohio State with 11-12 left to go. Trying the right side is Raymond Harris. He gets a couple. You're right. I thought it was a late hit, too, Tim. As Wilkinson came in, he was going for the loose ball, but it looked like Greg Smith that came up with the fumble there for Ohio State, who on the earlier turnover on the Zaire fumble was able to take it in for a touchdown. Second down and 8 from the 38-yard line. Chris Sanders, number 17, has checked in. And along with number 3, Greg Beatty, will split to the top of your screen. That play went nowhere. Raymond Harris found no room at all. Let's go down to Mark Jones. Mark?
Roger, I've got Jim Herbstreit, Kirk's father, the quarterback of Ohio State, former player and coach at Ohio State as well. What's going through your son's mind right now? What should he do?
Well, I hope it slowed down a little bit in throwing the ball. We're up against a great football team in Georgia, and we got a break here, and maybe we can break it open. But I think we just have to play sound fundamental football and not give it away, because neither team's going to give it away. And
once a coach, always a coach, right?
Thanks for joining us, Jim. All right, back upstairs to you guys.
Thanks, Mark. In other words, Dad says keep it on the ground. Third and 6, though, from the 40. Play action. Herbstreit just 5 of 16 today. They get it to Robert Smith, and he has got the first down. Smith has got more as he cuts it back. Smith inside the 20. Spins, and finally is tackled at the 15-yard line by Greg Trimble. 45 yards on the pickup. You take no chances in the fourth quarter. If you're going to throw it, you throw it to the guy that can really make something happen.
You talk about a well-designed play. Everything goes left, comes back, throws backside. Now watch the block he picks out here from long 66. Now it's open field, and you're watching a talented runner right here. Robert Smith does try to fool Trimble, 24, spins him around and can't get by him.
That's the longest play for Ohio State today, and Herbstreit has thrown just one interception in his last 190 attempts. He's been most accurate as the ball goes to Butler Benote, and he's tripped up after a gain of about 1 by Mitch Davis, the junior from Mobile, Alabama. So with 9:17 left to go, Ohio State and Georgia tied at 14.
Boy, Mitch Davis showed you some strength right there. You said 6'3", 237. That doesn't always tell you how strong a guy is. He just reached out and threw him to the ground.
We're going to mark that ball at the 16-yard line, so no gain on that play.
Wow, what a turnaround. Georgia's down here in scoring position, at least field goal position. They fumble, and now here come the Buckeyes.
Cochran, Benote, the setbacks. Sanders, the man in motion. The intended receiver there was Beatty. There were 3 defensive players back there from Georgia, and one of them is hurt at the 5-yard line. That's Chris Wilson, who's now being helped up by Casey Barnum, the nose tackle.
Yeah, Ohio State got a little salty right there. They brought Sanders out to set a little pick and hopefully ran Beatty by him, trying to rub off his man, and it didn't work.
Ohio State 2 of 2 in the red zone, and right now, Tim, they're faced with a 3rd down and 11. At the 16-yard line.
Coming into the game, they felt like they could really put the pressure on Herbstreit.
6 of 14 in third down situation so far today. Nicks up, fumble.
Georgia's got it.
Georgia did get it. At the 20-yard line, Travis Jones, 51, was the man that covered it. Looked like Herbstreit might have checked off at the line of scrimmage.
I think he had a misread. We were just talking about Georgia feeling they can put the pressure on Herbstreit. Now they're coming with the blitz. He doesn't see the blitz right away, and all of a sudden, here comes 53 right up the slot. That's Damon Ward. Ball's loose because he's looking at the blitz man and dropped it.
Well, Cothran ran right into it. The fullback, number 8, watch him. Somebody went the wrong way.
There's a mix-up unquestionably right there.
So the turnover gives Georgia the ball first and 10.
I'm not sure.
20-yard line.
I'm not sure he didn't try to check off.
That's what I think.
And they didn't hear him.
Garrison Hurst, right side. First down to the 33.
It is showtime for Robert Smith and Garrison Hurst.
13 yards on the pickup. Let's bring you all up to date on what's happened so far in this football game from Orlando. First quarter, Garrison Hurst, the one-yard touchdown run. First drive for Georgia. Then Robert Smith, after the turnover, gets the TD. Then Hurst, the five-yard touchdown run in the third. Smith, a five-yard touchdown run. That's where we're at. Both of these teams have just committed turnovers in the other team's territory. And it's second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Garrison Hurst. Stepping his way to the 45.
He's now past his average. He averages 141 yards a game. He's got 143 now. And I'm telling you, you can look at him and tell that he is feeling it. He's got the rhythm, and he's playing extremely well.
144 yards rushing. In 8 of 11 games this year, the University of Georgia has rushed for over 200 yards. The only game they didn't rush for at least 100 was the Ole Miss game.
Feet are moving so quick through those holes, he looks like a guy tap dancing on the light bulb.
First and 10, 44-yard line. 7:45 to go. Terrell Davis, 33. In there, right now for the University of Georgia. The play action, Zaire down the middle. He's got his tight end, Shannon Mitchell. Mitchell inside the 35, and let's go to Mark Jones. Mark?
Yeah, Tim, Roger, Kirk Herbstreit just told me what happened on that last Ohio State fumble. He checked off at the line of scrimmage. He told me he called red. The fullback thought he said right. Because of the noise, of course, he couldn't hear him, hence the ensuing fumble. Back up to you guys.
Okay, Mark, thanks so much. Well, that's what we thought had happened, as a timeout's been called by Ohio State.
Looks like Chico Nelson's been shaken
down.
Up.
So an official timeout. Official timeout was 7:34. As Chico Nelson shaken up on that last play, and we're going to take a pause here. Ohio State and Georgia tied at 14. We'll be right back to the Citrus Bowl. And today's attendance, 65,861, third highest attendance in stadium history. First and 10, 35-yard line. Second man through, number 33, the ball carrier, Terrell Davis, a sophomore from San Diego. Good surge there, gets about 4. Greg Smith, the nose tackle, and Craig Powell, the freshman backer, number 84, 6'5", 230. They say this guy can run step for step with Robert Smith in wind sprints after practice.
John Cooper, very, very sensitive when his team's speed is questioned. That became an item here the last couple of days. He says his linebackers are as fast, if not faster, than everybody in the country.
Second and let's call it 7. Hastings comes in motion at the 32-yard line. They're going to swing it to Hastings. A lead run tackle. Gets down as a penalty marker is thrown to the 26-yard line.
It's going
to
be a face mask, Roger, against Ohio State. 5-yard incidental.
Tackle made by Jim Walker.
Face mask, 5-yard penalty.
Tim, you're just too good up here. You got all the calls.
Stop it. Don't start.
You got all the calls. So a little swing pass to Hastings. He was able to pick up nearly enough for the first down, but with the 5-yard penalty tacked on now, first and 10. As they move the ball to the 21-yard line with 6:36 left to go. Garrison Hurst back in there. He'll set up deep in the eye. Penalty marker goes down. 57, Greg Smith, the senior med school student.
He knows it too, Roger. Very frustrated. He tried to anticipate the count, wanted to get that big jump. Just came across. Look at that face. I almost had it.
Academic All-American.
A couple critical mistakes right there.
We have offside on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Field first down.
Well, this has been a rather penalty-free football game. As you look at Smith, who has been very consistent in the middle. 63, 62, and 62 tackles the last 3 years. And you see just five penalties so far in the game today, and two by Ohio State here in just the last few seconds. And coming up next, the Rose Bowl, Michigan against Washington, right after this game between Georgia and Ohio State. First and five from the 16-yard line. His first moves up to the slot on the far side as they give it to Max Strong. And Strong trying to get it outside. They get it inside the 15, and they spot it down at the 13-yard line. It's a gain of about three that time. As Craig Powell, 84, and Tim Walton, 18, were over there to make the tackle. So they gave you a little bit different look that time. They used Hurst as a blocker, and they let Max Strong.
Roger Harper, the strong safety, showed you why. He's an all-conference player, too. He's the guy that strung it out all the way across the field laterally so the pursuit guys can come up and make the tackle.
Less than 6 minutes to go. Second down and two on the 14-yard line. Zier checking off the line of scrimmage. They give it to Hurst. He is stuck. Hurst goes nowhere. Going to be short of the first down. Lorenzo Styles, number 90, the freshman from Farrell, Pennsylvania. He's 6'3", 230-pounder. They've got some good young linebackers with Styles and Powell. And this is going to bring up Tim a third down and two. What do you think here? Maybe go to the end zone, if not settle for the field goal?
Well, defensively, you got to be thinking you're coming with the power. But it's not a bad time to throw to the wide side, and I would roll Zier that direction so he can run if nobody's open.
They'll give it to Hurst. He gets outside. He's got the first down. Hurst! They say he stepped out at the 5-yard line. Man, is he quick. When he hits that corner, he cuts it upfield so fast.
How about that, too? We're talking about coming to the wide side of the field. Ohio State had loaded this way, and then Georgia goes back to the boundary. You talk about breaking tendencies and predictability.
Garrison Hurst has had a big-time day.
When in doubt, give it to Hurst. He'll make it happen even if there's nothing there. Watch how close this is. Becoming a touchdown. He just barely touched the white line right there.
25 carries, 152 yards for Garrison Hurst. First and goal, 5-yard line. First back throughs Harvey. Georgia players looking for a signal as Frank Harvey, number 7, takes it down very close to the goal line. You can see where that ball spotted. Craig Powell, 84, made the tackle. So with the clock running, 4:50 left to go in this game, Georgia just inches from taking the lead against Ohio State. Harvey 7, Hurst 5, the running backs. Max Strong in the slot to the left. Harvey the first back through. Yeah, they got the signal. Touchdown.
Have talked a great deal about the Ohio State offensive linemen, but how about the Georgia Bulldogs? Watch Swan, the center, and Roberts and Taylor. Watch the push they get. Then here he comes, big Frank Harvey, 243 pounds. He's like a guard himself. He's in right there. Touchdown.
Point after attempt is good by Todd Peterson.
Now the question is, did Georgia score too quickly? Still 4:32 left.
21-14, Bulldogs lead it.
Like an old friend, the Rose Bowl starting to fill up on New Year's Day. Washington and Michigan, the Huskies trying to win for the third straight time. I send you back to Roger Twivel. Roger.
Thanks, Brent. Georgia leads Ohio State 21-14 after they take the turnover, march down the field, get the touchdown from that man, Frank Harvey. Just his third rushing touchdown of the year. You see the scoring drive, 11 plays, 80 yards. Very unlike Georgia to take that many plays, but the time, yeah, that's more consistent with that quick strike offense, about 4 minutes.
Yes, it is. You know, at the very beginning of this game, we said Ohio State would be keying on Garrison Hurst. Well, Hurst has had a big day. But then we said it could be Zaire and Hastings would have to pick up the slack. And Hastings today, 8 receptions, 114 yards, and that's a Georgia Bowl record.
4:32 left to go. Georgia 21, Ohio State 14 is Peterson. Will kick it off. Benote will take it at the 10. Near side, Butler Benote at the 35-yard line. So pretty good field position as we take a look at the game summary so far today. Hurst 151 yards rushing, a couple of touchdowns. The Bulldogs 440 total yards. Sounds familiar, doesn't it, Tim? Pretty
it
close
sure
to
does.
What that per game record was this year. And Hastings, as you mentioned, the Buckeye Smith 112 yards rushing. Tovar 8 tackles, the forced fumble and a sack. So the players who came into this game being touted as the big play individuals for their respective teams have shown up and played well today. First and 10, 35-yard line. First loose play action, flushed out of the pocket and dumped. Look there, Mitch Davis, 58, the junior from Mobile, Alabama. He's been a force to be reckoned with this afternoon.
He's played everywhere in that defense, too. He's a Parade High School All-American, now a junior, but he's played inside linebacker, played at safety, played some outside linebacker, and the thing he does better than anything is run to the football. Look at him here. Breaks down, not taken by any fake by Herbstreit, and chases him from behind.
Yeah, Tim, in all honesty, this is where Ohio State gets in trouble, late in the game when they're behind. Their offense is just not geared to come from behind and throw the football. Davis has got 2 sacks to hit. They know. Play fake. Yeah, play action is not going to fool many people when you're down by a touchdown with less than 4 minutes to go. Second and 17. Underneath, they go to Cochran. Cochran trying to make something happen. Went backwards after he got up to the 34-yard line as Mike Jones, the senior from Thomasville, Georgia, 6'3 and 220. Speaking of Thomasville, you know who's from Thomasville, Georgia, don't you? Or Julie Moran.
Julie's from Thomasville, yeah. Huh? I know she's a Georgia fan, and her granddaddy played there, coached there.
And Mike just happens to be the brother of Sean, the Georgia Tech quarterback.
Oh, I did know that. Yeah. I did know that.
Third down and 11. 3:16. Left to go in this football game. Georgia leads it 21-14. Back on the coverage, Mike Jones, number 9, to knock it down. The intended receiver, Cedric Saunders, the tight end, and they call him the dean of the defense with 26 consecutive starts.
He has been that today, too. He's played extremely well. They moved Jones out to the outside early on. They brought him on some blitzes. He's been in that strong safety spot. He's been good against the run and pass defense.
Fourth down and 11 as Joel Kessel needs to get a big punt. Andre Hastings back deep. Look at his return yards today. He's back at the 25-yard line. And Kessel, it's a high spiral to the near side. It's going to go out of bounds, and the official running up the field and up the field. And Georgia is going to get it at the 39-yard line. 28 yards. On the punt by Joel Kessel. And with 2:51 left to go, the Buckeyes, with just 2 timeouts remaining, trail it 21-14. And now, this Ohio State defense, which has been the backbone of the Buckeye team all year, and keep in mind that Ohio State has not lost a football game since Illinois beat them back in October the 10th. They've got to come through at this time.
They cannot allow a first down. They're banking on getting the ball back with a minute left in the game.
Split backs. Now Hurst will shift back along with Max Strong, number 32. First. That's back. A lot of moving around. Maybe gets a yard to the 41-yard line.
They've got two timeouts left. As you mentioned, they're going to save it. They're going to save one for offense. They are not taking one here. The clock continues to move at 2:34. Zaire content to take his time. Play clock down to 15 seconds.
In the Mobile Cotton Bowl, Notre Dame beats Texas A&M 28-3. First loss for the Aggies this year. In Blockbuster Bowl, Stanford 24-3 over Penn State. Second and 10 from the 40. Hurst cuts it outside. One tackle is missed. Hurst is going to get the first down across midfield to the 48-yard line. Tim Walton makes the tackle 12 yards on the pickup by Garrison Hurst as he just keeps on running and running and running. And John Cooper, the head coach at Ohio State, trying to urge his team on. They've got two timeouts left, 1:55 left to go. Cooper, the first coach in Ohio State history to lose three consecutive bowl games, is in danger of losing his fourth straight bowl game with the Buckeyes. And there's a look at Garrison Hurst. January 6th is the D.
Hurst very wisely stayed in bounds too, Roger.
He's running hard off the left side, and look at this Georgia team has fought back. Jason Simmons, 91, made the stop, and Ohio State's going to burn a timeout. They'll have one left with 1:27 to go here from the Florida Citrus Bowl. Ohio State, then John Cooper, 8-2-1 this year. Lost a couple close games early in the year to Wisconsin and Illinois, and the tie with Michigan. Ray Goff feeling pretty good right now with 1:27 to go. Leads at 21-14, second and 5 at the 43-yard line, and the Buckeyes have just one timeout remaining. Tovar got in there, and they called timeout immediately at midfield. Boy, Steve Tovar was coming hard all the way that time, and that's going to set up a third down situation with 1:23. Left to go as Kirk Herbstreit thinking about what might have been and what maybe will be. As coming up next here from Pasadena, the granddaddy of them all, Michigan and Washington. Washington's got something to prove in this game. They kind of staggered at the end of the year, losing to Arizona and Washington State. And of course, Michigan, the way they fumbled away the game to Illinois and end up in a tie there and then with Ohio State. So be an interesting matchup between Michigan and Washington. Looked like about midway through the year, Tim, that'd be the game for the national championship.
Yeah, it sure did, especially the way Washington was going. But now that A&M has lost, I don't think anybody can sit back and say this isn't number one and number two playing tonight in the Sugar Bowl for the national title.
Let's see, Garrison Hurst, 163 yards. That's a Georgia bowl game record, 163 yards rushing. The Citrus Bowl record back years ago when it was a Tangerine Bowl by Jimmy Gray of East Texas State, 174 yards back in 1953. Another record today. Andre Hastings with 8 receptions now has become the all-time leading receiver, passing Lindsey Scott with 132 receptions. On 3rd and 12, Smith, the senior, jumped off sides. Now that's, you want to be aggressive, but it's not really necessary.
Dead ball foul. Still the clock doesn't move. 1:23 left. They move it up 5 yards. It'll still be third down, and they need a bunch.
We have offside on the defense, a 5-yard penalty, he'll be third down.
And then, of course, coming up tonight, the battle for number one, the U.S. F&G Sugar Bowl. From New Orleans, number one Miami, number two Alabama, it's the offense. Gino Toretta, a Heisman Trophy winning quarterback, and that great defense, number one ranked defense in the nation. The Crimson Tide of Alabama. Toretta's going to see a lot of Curry and Copeland. And Copeland and Curry,
the two All-Americans, and Gino, of course, the Heisman Trophy winner.
Third down and 7. Ohio State out of timeouts. Garrison Hurst tries to cut back up, and he is stopped at the 45-yard line. Derek Foster, 94, over there, the initial man to hit him. So Georgia now going to let this clock run down. And Ohio State.
Ohio State gambled that they get the ball back with about a minute left, and that's about what's going to happen here.
Ohio State is going to get the ball back.
Goff did not want the clock to stop.
It did at 111. Now they roll it again as they put it back in play. He's going to take every bit of that 25-second clock and let it go down, which would take the game clock down to about 47 seconds.
There it is. So the penalty, they call a timeout, Tim. Do they take the penalty or they call a timeout? Looks like the official signaled toward Georgia to take the timeout so that they didn't take the penalty. Yeah, so Georgia has used the timeout here.
That's one of those deals, Roger. You tell the official what you're going to do. We're going to let it go all the way down at 1 second. I do want a timeout. All right, what they did do is they let the game clock go one extra second. There's 46 seconds left instead of 47. But still, it's going to be one last opportunity for Ohio State.
Well, if Georgia wins this game today, they finish up the year at 10-2. And this is what they do in 93 with South Carolina, Tennessee, Texas Tech, Mississippi, Arkansas, Southern Miss, Vanderbilt, Kentucky, Florida, Auburn, and then Georgia Tech.
That's still a schedule that's conducive to a very fine record.
Ohio State, Washington, Pitt, then an open date. Look for that open date to be moved the week before the Washington game. They've got a young freshman quarterback, Bob Boyd. They want to get ready before that to throw in against Washington. And, of course, Penn State on the schedule next year. So Scott Armstrong had one punt blocked in his career out of 156 punts. Fourth down and seven. Robert Smith is back. And pretty good pressure that time. Line drive kick, and Smith's going to take it. Dunks to the near side, out of bounds at the 18-yard line with 37 seconds left to go, and we'll just keep it right here at the Florida Citrus Bowl. And John Cooper,
very smart by Robert Smith just to get to the sideline, get up near the 20, got to about the 19, and stop the clock.
Stay with us here on ABC Sports for this Florida Citrus Bowl with Georgia and Ohio State. Coming up next is the Rose Bowl. Ohio State with it. First and 10. And mark it at the 19-yard line.
You just have to throw it and hope.
37 seconds left to go. They need the touchdown. Two-point conversion to win it. Herb Street moves up in the pocket. Still moving. Now he's going to run it. Herb Street slides. He's got the first down, and that'll stop the clock as he's up to the 40-yard line. So that's what they need to do, get a couple of quick first downs here to get that clock stopped. And now Herb Street trying to get his guys back in position. With 27 seconds left to go. Ball at the 36-yard line, and he throws it right down. And that'll stop it with 25 seconds left.
Good heady play by Herb Street. Buys a little bit of time, at least to come back in.
Oh, Tim, we were talking a little bit earlier about John Cooper's situation at Ohio State University. He told us the other day in regards to his contract situation that he's got just signed a new contract, has 3 years remaining. But Dr. Gee said earlier in December that he says, well, he'll definitely be back next year. Without that long-range commitment, without that planning that goes into it, it's kind of hard to go out and recruit kids when there's a question in their minds whether the coach can be around another year or not.
Well, that's why they gave him at least that one-year commitment, so that it would not hurt the recruiting for this year. But you're right, the speculation, if I'm a kid and I'm saying, am I going to Ohio State, is Cooper going to be there? I know the alumni has been very hard on him, and it will be until he can beat Michigan.
And win a bowl game.
Right.
Trips to the near side on second down and 10. Penalty markers down. Herb Street eludes one tackler. Got a man open down the far side and overthrown. The intended receiver was Chris Sanders. Looked like he lost sight of the football. Had a defender back there jumping up in front of him, Greg Trimble. But a penalty marker is down with 18 seconds to go, and might have been some movement in that Ohio State backfield.
I think it was. I think it was the wide receivers actually started to move before the snap.
So the procedure penalty, I think it was 42 William Houston, who was having a hard time getting set up in the backfield. He was in there to help block. Once again, Stabline, the leading receiver for Ohio State, out with the knee injury.
Got a shot there briefly on the sidelines of Eric Zier, and folks, he is some kind of player.
Second down, 15 from the 31-yard line. And that should be pass interference, and it is. Right at midfield. 53, Damon Ward was right in the back of Alan DeGraffenried. So 13 seconds remain.
Watch this. Damon Ward doesn't even try to hide it. Here he is to the right of your screen. Number 53. Look, just shoves him from behind. I think he felt he's going to make this catch anyway. I'm just going to go ahead and drill him. Mark it off, 15 yards, and there it is.
John Cooper, who's gone through a lot of changes on his coaching staff the last couple of years. It'll be interesting to see what next year holds for Cooper and the Ohio State Buckeyes. First and 10 from the 48-yard line. Herb Street trying to go to the sideline and out of bounds. Cedric Saunders, the tight end, makes the catch. Just 7 seconds now remain. They mark it at the 49-yard line, and I think this might be a good time, Tim, to go downfield with it.
That's it. They only have one play left, so they've got to throw it up as far as he can and just do the old Hail Mary.
We'll send trips to the near side. 7 seconds left to go. 21-14. Georgia leads Ohio State, and Herb Street will throw it with all of his might. Intercepted, number 9, Mike Jones, his second interception of the year, and the Georgia Bulldogs have beaten the Buckeyes of Ohio State 21-14 in the Florida Citrus Bowl. For Mark Jones and Tim Brandt, I'm Roger Tribal. Thanks for being with us from Orlando, Florida. Georgia beat Ohio State 21-14. Coming up next here on ABC Sports is the Rose Bowl. So long, everybody, and Happy New Year.